Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Findlay Stadium for tonight's matchup between the McCauley Blue Tornado and the War Eagles of Woodward Academy. David Eastman here alongside Coach Rick Witt. And, Coach, it's good to have you back for another season of Blue Tornado football.
Great to be back. Good seeing you, David.
So, big matchup here tonight for the Blue Tornado. Rematch of a game played last year on this same field, and I think throughout the course of the evening we'll revisit that. But here come the War Eagles now. One of the things that we know about this matchup from last year is that it's going to be physical on both sides of the ball, Coach.
Very, very physical. I mean, that's the way McCauley plays, and when you watch them on film, they're very aggressive, and they chase the ball, you know, basically do everything that the kind of way McCauley does it. Very physical, chase the ball, get a bunch of people around the ball, and very physical on offense as well. So,
a lot of talent on both sides of the field tonight, and we'll talk about that more again throughout the course of the evening. Some major Power 5 commits on both sides, and certainly Woodward brings a whole slew of guys who fall into that category. So McCauley's going to kick off here to start the first half, going right to left. So kicking east to west, the lights are on here at Findlay Stadium. The sun is down over Lookout Mountain to our left. It's still about 98 degrees outside, Coach, but we're up here in the air conditioning. That's right, and you're home, hopefully sitting somewhere comfortably as well. As Elliot Arnold, number 99, prepares to put his foot into the ball. The kick is deep.
Nice kick.
And into the end zone, where it's going to be a touchback. High school rules, automatic touchback fielded in the end zone there by Josiah Abdullah, who is a major Division I prospect but unable to bring the ball out. So the War Eagles, 1-0, a big win last week for them, coached by John Hunt. And here they come for the first offensive play from the 20-yard line, and certainly key players include the senior running back C.J. Hurd and London Merritt, who's going to play on the defensive and offensive side of the ball. So let's see. They come out in formation with three receivers to the far side of the field.
Trips tight.
That's Lucas Farragut in motion, or Farrington, correction, and a flag is down. Illegal procedure before they can get the first snap off for the War Eagles, so they go back 5 yards. Griffin Marshall, the senior quarterback, 6'2", will be in the backfield tonight, again, flanked by Farrington on the first play. And so now the War Eagles are looking at first and 15 from the 15-yard line. Just underway here at Findlay Stadium. New formation for the War Eagles. One receiver to the far side, two to the near side of the field. Shotgun snap. Man in motion. Quick throw out to the right side. A wide receiver screen, couple of nifty moves, and gets about 7 yards. And that's a guy we're going to see a lot tonight, Coach. That's number 12, Ben Grice, the senior. Wake Forest commit. Yeah. Yes. Had a big game last year in this matchup against McCauley. And looking back at the stats, he had 119 receiving yards last year against McCauley. So no question the McCauley defensive coaches have a bullseye on his back tonight, and the importance of tackling the first time is going to be key. So now it's second down at 8 for the War Eagles. Fake handoff on the run-pass option. Griffin Marshall with a short gain.
Like Bear and Jaden, nice job there.
Brought down by the middle of that McCauley defensive line. First third down of the game. Third and 6. Third down was a situation last year in which both teams struggled. Both defenses played very well in this game. So first third down of the game, 3rd and 6. From the 24-yard line, 4 wide receivers for the War Eagles, Coach.
Spreading them out, trying to create some space here.
Back looking. Quick out to Grice. He's got, and he drops the ball, or did he fumble the ball? Let's see what the call is. It appears that they're going to mark it a fumble. If it's a fumble, it could be a first down. There's going to be a discussion. Grice seemed to have the ball. He turned, and then the ball just flopped out of his hands. It's incomplete.
Incomplete.
So after further review, it's a drop by Grice on 3rd and short. And the War Eagles will most likely punt. You can see they had already begun to move the chains on the far side of the field, so they have to bring the chains back, reset them at the 20, well, the 20 to the 30-yard line, so fourth and six from the 24-yard line. And we will get these names to you as soon as we can, folks. That's right, first punt of the night, and that's going to be number three, Carson Lawrence, is the deep man for McCauley. The punter looks like 21, J. Ellis Hood. Is that 21, Coach? No, yes, correction, sir. That's 81. 81 is Jonah Bloom, the senior. Last week we had two left-footed punters in that CCS McCauley game. I've never seen that, I think, two left-footed punters in the same game. The kick wobbly just over midfield. Lawrence lets it bounce, and that was probably not the best option as the ball rolls and rolls and rolls down to the 16-yard line. And that's where McCauley's going to take over. First and 10, a long field for the Blue Tornado on the first drive, but a good stop by the defense. 10:54 in the first quarter, no score from Finley Stadium. So good stop there, Coach, for the McCauley defense.
Yeah, nice job. Got a little bit of a break on the drop pass there. But.
So 59 yards is the total on that punt. Probably 35 in the air and 24 on the roll, but very effective punt for the War Eagles, and they pin the Blue Tornado back. First and 10 coming out from the 16. Coach Bradford talked with him this week, and he said it's very important for McCauley's offense to get off to a quick start, which has not always been the pattern in the last couple of games, including last week, and we have a flag down, and before the first play on offense, we have another 5-yard penalty for an illegal procedure. So both offenses sputtering out of the gate tonight, and certainly not the start that Coach Bradford was looking for. He mentioned last week, slow start on offense, and maybe kind of a pattern that happened late in the season last year. They were hoping to improve on that this year. Hand off McMahon up the middle. Lots of room. Twisting to the outside. Gets the looks like close to 10 yards on that, so it's going to be second down and 5. That's Javon McMahon, wearing number 23 tonight.
Good player.
The senior running back had a big game last week for McCauley, relatively speaking. And one thing we saw last year, Coach, I look back at the totals, the rushing totals for both teams last year were very low. So there was not much room to run the ball last year. There's been man out of the backfield, catching it, turning the corner, and that's a first down for the Blue Tornado at the 29-yard line. Yeah, so, Coach, in last year's game, 46 yards on the ground for McCauley and 56 for Woodward Academy. That was a very uncharacteristic game. But, again, as we talked about, physical game with two good defenses.
Yeah. This group's a 4-3, and they're an attacking-type defense. They move guys around up front. And I think they were playing quarters and ran people off and got the back outside the linebacker. So.
Yeah, McCauley did it 242 yards in the air last year in this matchup, which is not normally the McCauley way, but it was. And here, quarterback keeper around the edge, Jay St. Hilaire. And that's going to be another McCauley first down out to the 43-yard line. So a good start here for the McCauley offense after initially a penalty. Then a good run by McMahon, catch out of the backfield, and now St. Hilaire on the rollout, the senior. McCauley out to the 43-yard line now, first and 10. Clock running under 10 minutes in the first quarter. And certainly McCauley looking tonight, keeping an eye on London Merritt on the defense for the War Eagles. There's a pass out to Carson Lawrence. He makes a move back to the inside and gets about 9 yards. Brought down by R.J. Harrison, the junior cornerback. Lawrence, the Vanderbilt commit, the junior, with a nice catch and run, gets about 9 yards. Coach sets him up with a very favorable second and short.
Yeah, they're playing quarters over there, and they kept that linebacker close to the box to try to make sure if they're going to run the ball, and that's created a good play for us.
There's McMahon up the middle, twisting and spinning for another McCauley first down. So, Coach, when you say they're playing quarters, tell us a little bit about what that means. From
two deep, the corner's got the number one, the free safety, or the safety's got number two. And they can be reading it out or just playing them locking on, and then that puts the linebacker, of course, as the edge player. And then there they cheated him to the box to protect against the run, which opened up a bunch of space down there for Carson.
So it's the cat and mouse game of what's the defense giving you and how you can kind of go opposite what they're doing.
Yeah, that's right.
which is an area where, you know, Coach Bradford certainly has shown his ability to play that game well. And fake by St. Hilaire, looking wide open as Nolan Sargent down the sidelines. Incomplete.
Nice job.
Nice job by the defender. That's J. Ellis Hood, who got back into coverage. But looked like Sargent kind of on a wheel route there, and I wasn't clear exactly what the misconnection was at the end. Looked like the ball was there. Maybe just the defender got in the way. And
well, he finally saw it. He was the one receiver was inside, so it took the corner, and then all of a sudden he saw it and came off and made a pretty good play there.
So missed opportunity there on the long pass down the left side. Brings up second down and 10 for the Blue Tornado.
Still playing quarters.
St. Hilaire under pressure. Flag is down. That's going to come back on a hold. He scrambles forward for a couple of yards. But that's going to be a hold on the edge against McCauley. And I think the man being held was that man, London Merritt, the junior. Listed at 6'3", 235, and with lots and lots of offers.
Yeah, he's got a lot of offers, yeah. And when you watch him on tape, you see why.
And Coach Bradford said you watch the film, he jumps off the film. And last year initially started well. But that second half of the game, you saw actually the McCauley offensive line began to lean on him a little bit and maybe turn that to their advantage. We'll see. He's a year older, a year stronger, and McCauley has four new starters. So it could be a different dynamic tonight up front for the Blue Tornado. But obviously a very talented player coming off the edge and very dangerous coming off the edge. Let's see how McCauley handles him tonight. It's now second down and long. St. Hilaire, short pass out to the right. Pass complete down the sideline. And inside the 15-yard line, that's number 24, Keyshawn Tabuteau, made the catch, broke a tackle, and breaks a long offensive play down to the 5-yard line of the War Eagles. So, Coach, just a little short out, and really in that place, the wide receiver made the play, 47 yards for a first and goal.
He is let them run this play here.
Hand off, that's McMahon up the middle, and nothing doing. Hit right at the point of attack by Andrew Hines, senior linebacker.
You're talking with the coaches. Young man could be pretty special. He's very fast and trying to get the ball in his hands and let him make somebody miss and do just what he did, take it 47 yards.
And Tabuteau, just a sophomore, yeah. So yeah. Lot to see from him yet in his McCauley career. A loss of about a yard, it looks like, brings up second down and goal. The yard marker shows first, but it is second down. Clock under 7.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. No score. McCauley threatening for second and goal now. Hand off on the inside. And maybe a yard or two. Ryan Larrabee, the junior. McCauley tries to run a little misdirection. The inside hand off to Larrabee. Gets the yard lost and one. So third down and four now for McCauley. Third and goal from the 4-yard line. Clock running under 7 minutes to go. First quarter, no score. War Eagles took the opening kickoff, unable to move the ball. Punted to McCauley. Now McCauley on the heels of a big play. St. Hilaire to Tabuteau now inside the 5. Third down and goal. Tight formation. St. Hilaire on the quarterback sweep. And he is very close. Looks like they're going to mark him down inside the 1 or right around the 1-yard line. Fourth and goal, Coach. First big call of the game.
I think we're going for it. You get it down there on the 1-yard line this early in the game.
This is where the big defensive line for the War Eagles can certainly come into play. St. Hilaire up the middle, not having a lot of space, but it looks like the road grader approach, yeah. And it's a touchdown. The McCauley scores first. Jay St. Hilaire on the 1-yard quarterback sneak, and with 6:12 remaining in the first quarter, it's now McCauley 6 and Woodward nothing.
Coach Bradford did a nice job there, as he always does. A lot of different formations in the first drive. See how people are going to line up against him so he can come back, make some adjustments, and do some things.
Arnold on to attempt the extra point. The kick is up, and it is good. And so McCauley on the first offensive drive goes down the field and scores with 6:12 remaining in the first quarter. It's now McCauley 7 and Woodward 0. Last year's game, it was Woodward who went out on top with a field goal. And really, last year's game, almost all the scoring happened in the first half. It was a 14-13 game at half, ended up 17-13. So even not a lot of scoring by McCauley standards or Woodward standards in last year's game. So we'll see how that plays out tonight. 7-0 now McCauley. The trouble's on the scoreboard here in the stadium, but it is 7-0. And Elliot Arnold will be on to kick. And back deep. Well, no, there's a stoppage in play. Is it a required? Looks like it's a required heat break, is what we're being told. So I guess if they were playing college or pro, it'd be time for a commercial break. So 6:12 remaining in the first quarter. McCauley has taken a 7-0 lead, and they're taking a short break. We'll take it with them. We'll be right back in 30 seconds or a minute. As soon as the officials allow the players back on the field, we'll keep the video feed live, and we'll be right back with the audio. McCauley has taken an early 7-0 lead. So we're back here ready for the kickoff. The heat break has come to an end, and Elliot Arnold will tee it up. Back deep for Woodward. We know 13, Josiah Abdullah's back there, and I will try to pick out the other deep man. It might be C.J. Hurd. I think it's number one Hurd. Arnold puts his foot into it. It's a low liner, and it will just cross the plane of the goal. And so it's an automatic touchback. You saw Abdullah wanted to bring the ball out, but by rule, unable to do so, and that's definitely a weapon, Coach. When you have talented players like Abdullah and Hurd back there, you don't want to give them a running start at the defense.
Don't give them chance, and great luxury to have a guy that can kick it in the end zone.
It was touchback after touchback, and a couple of the kicks last week actually went out of the end zone on the kickoff. So definitely, as you say, a weapon for the Blue Tornado. Here come the War Eagles, trailing 7-0. Four wide look again, spreading out the defense. Quarterback Marshall takes a snap. Handoff up the middle. That's Lucas Farrington. Tripped up after a gain of about one. Tripped up by the middle of that line. It might have been Jaden Hudgens-Key in on that play. Short gain of a yard, second down and 9 for the War Eagles. Same formation, single back, four wide receivers. Grice is on the far side, keep an eye on him. Looking out the flat, the ball is dropped right in the breadbasket, another drop. And that was Josiah Abdullah, the junior wide receiver, and that was a first down, Coach. Another first down, missed opportunity for the War Eagles, but right out in the flat, good play design. The throw was right on the money from Marshall, but could not complete the catch, and so it's now third and long.
That's tough on the safety right there because he's got to play inside, honor the inside, protect the inside, and then they run a deep out over there. And it's tough for him to get to there, get there.
And obviously, Abdullah is a tremendously talented player, very fast. So you can't cheat up on that. You really got to give him space. And now we have three to the near side, back looking to the left, passes through the hands again. That was Jerome Bettis Jr., the junior wide receiver, and Coach, again, that looked like it was right in his face mask, and just slips through his hands. And the War Eagles will have to punt again. McCauley defense catching some breaks there with some really good passes from Marshall that seemed to be on time and on target. Unable to make the connection with the wide receivers, and so McCauley's going to get the ball back here with 5:27 in the first quarter. Last time it was a 59-yard punt. It's in the air this time, and Lawrence fields it at the 35. up to the 40, 45 off the right side and brought down there by number 44. That's Aiden Hughes, the senior, who brings down Lawrence at the 47-yard line. Last time McCauley started at 16, this time out by the 47. 43 yards on the punt. About 12 on the return from Lawrence. So much better field position for McCauley, not in the shadow of their own end zone as they come out for the second drive. And obviously, Coach, McCauley catching some breaks with these incompletions. This is a chance for them really to put themselves out ahead, especially against a talented team like the War Eagles. So yes. Big drive here for both teams.
Got a little momentum.
St. Hilaire under center. There's a handoff. That's McMahon. Tries to cut it outside, and he's not going to go anywhere. Lost a couple yards. Andrew Hines, again, the senior linebacker. He's been in on a couple of plays.
Yep.
Been in the backfield several times, and we actually saw that pattern last week a number of times where McMahon would try to go up the middle, wasn't there, he would bounce it. But against this talented War Eagles front, not having as much success tonight. Now, of course, last week, the first quarter and a half, close game, not much going, and then the middle, second quarter, the offensive line and the offense got the running game going. So we'll see how that plays out tonight as well for McCauley. Second and 13, shotgun snap. There's a handoff again, McMahon, up the middle, finding some space, but about 3 yards is all, and he's going to bring up third down and 10 for McCauley. Looked like the middle of that defense, including Aiden Hughes again. Just had the tackle on the punt return, and now the tackle on the run, and third down and 10 for McCauley. Clock running 4:13 and rolling in the first quarter, 7-0 McCauley. Coming to the near side, that's Matthew Hebert. Two wide receivers to the far side. McMahon in motion. St. Hilaire looking. Pressure. Throws.
Nice
caught.
Job. A little short.
Caught by Hebert, but it's going to be, as you say, Coach, about a yard short. So now you have fourth and one, but it's at the 44-yard line instead of the one-yard line, as we saw a few minutes ago. And McCauley moving up to the line quickly. Looks like they're going to go for it. Boy, big play here in the game. If the War Eagles could get a stop, this could shift the momentum. Fourth and one. It's St. Hilaire again up the middle, and he's going to get it. But there's a flag that comes in very, very late from the referee. So a push from St. Hilaire. Looks like he got the first down on yardage. Well, it's very close. The ball's being marked right at the 43-yard line. That's right where the sticks were.
Yeah.
The penalty is... The signal was pushing. I think that used to be a penalty. I see it all the time in football now. It appears that they call it a penalty for aiding the runner, which, again, used to be against the rules, but you see a lot of teams, that's their whole strategy.
In college and pros, that's what they've done.
It looks like that was the call. The official just made a motion with his hands below his hips, kind of pushing forward. It's some kind of 5-yard penalty. It's fourth and six. And so McCauley's punting away. The ball hits at the 20. Rolling now inside the 10. Good punt, good roll there for McCauley. And it's down at the 4-yard line. Enrique James LeClaire, the left-footed punter, and that's a very good outcome for McCauley. The ball
45-yard punt.
Rolls down inside the 5, 45 yards, no return.
Yeah, that's an interesting call because they didn't do it when we scored.
I was thinking the same thing. Similar play, yes. And you certainly see offenses where they bring three players right up behind the quarterback, and that is the play. Now, again, when I was young, that was illegal.
It was illegal.
But I haven't seen that called in, I don't know, I'm not going to reveal how old I am. It's been a long time since I've seen that called, and we saw it here tonight on third and short. So, fourth and short. So it's now first and 10, 3:13 first quarter. Woodward coming out from the shadow of their own goalpost. Man in motion. Play action looking deep down the left side. Grice is out there, and he's got it. And he is out to the 45-yard line and falls down. There's a big connection from Marshall to Grice. We talked about Ben Grice had a big game last year, and that's a 42-yard line, a 38-yard connection from Marshall to Grice coming out of the their own end, and now it's first and 10 at the 42. Deshaun Tipton out there in coverage for McCauley, but good speed from Grice got behind him, and now Grice comes at a near side in the slot. First and 10. Handoff up the middle.
Nice job.
Short gain there for C.J. Hurd. And Carson Gentle at the bottom of the pile. Another flag is down on the near side of the field. Thrown toward the offense, so I'm assuming this is going to be an offensive penalty, but let's see. They're talking to the McCauley coaches, either... Let's see what the call is here.
Illegal shift.
Illegal shift, okay, on the offense. McCauley has the choice. So no gain on the play, I think is where they were marking it. They're asking Coach Potter if he wants the penalty or the yardage.
He's declined it.
He has declined it, so it's going to be second down and 10. So no gain on the play, second down and 10 from the 42-yard line. Correction, that was Farrington on the carry. No gain, second and 10. Two receivers to the near side, Abdallah and Grice, two very dangerous wideouts. And that's Farrington in motion. Play action, out to the left side. Pass is intended for Farrington. I think he caught it, sliding down at the 48-yard line. And that was Lucas Farrington.
Just a nice thrown catch there.
And the junior, completion of 6 yards, brings up third down and 4 at the 48-yard line. War Eagles have the ball, clock just over 2 minutes, 2:07 and running. First quarter, 7-0 McCauley. Here come the War Eagles, four wide receivers, three to the near side, one to the far side.
Like we're playing man.
Farrington in motion, looking right, rolling, throwing, and it is almost intercepted. Pass intended for Josiah Abdullah, who's very unhappy about the outcome of that play.
Nice job of Chosen.
That was Chosen Lekumbe, who stepped in front and almost had the pick. So no turnover, Coach, but a big play on third down by Chosen Lekumbe.
Yeah, nice job.
And you can see
quarterback's pretty good when he gets outside the pocket. And so making a play like that's really good.
Yeah, design roll out there from Griffin Marshall. Unable to make the connection. And so Jonah Bloom back again to kick, and Carson Lawrence awaits the kick. Somebody rushing on here at the last second for the punt coverage for the War Eagles. 1:51 in the first quarter. Bloom takes a snap, kick, hits at the 20, bouncing. At that, they stop. Oh, into the end zone. Boy, that was very dangerous, Coach.
Close.
You saw Lawrence go that direction, then kind of hesitate, and by the time it got past him, you were just hoping, if you're a McCauley fan, you were hoping it was going to keep going, and it did. It goes in the end zone for 52 yards, 32 on the net. And McCauley will have the ball at the 20-yard line. But, yeah, Coach, for a moment there, you kind of held your breath if you're a McCauley fan. You don't want to start at the 2-yard line or the 1-yard line.
I think the way he saw it, it was spinning pretty good. And that was certainly the right thing to do.
Here comes McCauley again, the third drive of the game. So a touchdown and then an unsuccessful drive last time out near midfield. The penalty, a big play on the last drive against McCauley. Here they come out. First and 10 to 20-yard line. Hand off at the middle. There's McMahon. He's got some room. 6, 7, 8, 9 yards. Looks like he's going to be just short of a first down. 9 yards on the play. Tyree Myrick. He was on the play there for the War Eagles. Second down and 1. Clock running 1:20 in the first quarter. McCauley to the line. Again, up the middle. McMahon. Nothing doing that time, but keeps driving forward and still marked as if he had lost about a half a yard. Met in the hole by 33, Amari Irvin, a freshman out there for the War Eagles. They can tell you something about the talent of that young man if as a freshman he's on the field. So big hit in the hole. Big man unable to drive through and gain any yards, which brings up third down and 1 for McCauley. Play clock under 20, game clock under 45, first quarter. Here come the subs for McCauley. Phil Buteau comes out. Tight formation for the Blue Tornado. Handoff, hit in the backfield, and that's a loss. But here's a flag down. I think we're going to get a face mask. London Merritt with the first contact, but look like a face mask, and you saw the flag coming immediately from the far side of the field. Let's see the call. I think it's going to be a face mask on Merritt. But he was right there in the backfield. We've talked about London Merritt. You got to watch that guy. You see by his body language now, he's heard the call. It's going to be a first down for McCauley, but you can see how dangerous he is off the edge. Personal foul, face mask is 15 yards. A bit of a break there for McCauley on third and short.
Yeah, he is so quick that they do a lot of line stunts, you know, outside shade and jumping inside gap and stuff. And apparently that's what he just did. And
as we mentioned earlier, one returning starter, the right guard, Carson Kaufman, the only starter returning from last year. So this is trial by fire, learning of the job for these offensive linemen for McCauley. Health by the penalty. It's first down at the 44-yard line. St. Hilaire back, looking, steps up, down the sideline. The pass is intended for Carson Lawrence, and it falls incomplete. R.J. Harrison on the coverage out there, and 3-on-3.
Nice job by them.
Falls incomplete. Lawrence had a big catch in last year's game, unable to connect there with Jay St. Hilaire. Brings up second down and 10 from the 44-yard line. 4 seconds left in the first quarter. 7-0. McCauley comes out. Enrique James LeClaire to the near side. 5 wide receivers now for McCauley. St. Hilaire alone in the backfield. Shotgun snap coming. Back, looking. On the slant, that ball's caught by Sargent. Contact a little bit early. No call, but Sargent holds on to the ball. And that's going to come up a little short of the first down. I think it's going to be 3rd down and 1 for McCauley, but good connection there from Jay St. Hilaire to the senior Nolan Sargent. And the ball's going to be inside War Eagles territory at the 47-yard line, where it's going to be 3rd down and 1. When we come back, end of the first quarter, McCauley 7, Woodward nothing. We'll be right back on the McCauley Network. Back here awaiting the start of the second quarter. McCauley with 3rd down and 1. The ball resting on about the 47-yard line of the War Eagles. Correction, the ball has been moved back. Let's see what's happening here. Not exactly sure what's happening.
There we go.
Okay, so now it's 3rd down. 3rd down and 1 now for McCauley. Ball at the 47-yard line. Here comes McCauley. 3rd down and 1 from the 47-yard line of the War Eagles. Carson Gentle comes in motion, shotgun snap, St. Hilaire on the quarterback keeper, nothing doing, hit in the backfield and lost some yards. There's, again, 44, Aiden Hughes making the big play for the War Eagles, and that's going to bring up 4th down now and 5 for McCauley right around midfield.
Again, good movement by them up front. You know, sometimes it makes you miss it. And then that's what happens.
Enrique James LeClaire on to punt for McCauley. Ball resting at the 49-yard line of the Blue Tornado. Just underway in the second quarter. 7-0 McCauley. Left-footed. Ooh, a high kick, but that is off the side of his foot. And it's going to be marked. Well, let's see where they mark this ball. It's going to be outside the 40-yard line. Official coming up the sideline. This could be
It's like the 40.
The 40. I would say that's probably a generous spot. It looked like it landed around the 40-yard line. So as it stands for McCauley, that's an 11-yard punt. And the four Eagles will come out now first and 10, the ball resting on their own 40-yard line. So a big break there for McCauley, or for the War Eagles. So first downs in that first quarter, McCauley 5, Woodward only 1 first down. So let's see how things progress in the second quarter defensively. Big defensive battle last year. We're seeing that again this year. Here come the War Eagles, first down from the 40-yard line. Looks like some pressure coming off the edge. Griffin back, here's the pressure up the middle, and he is down. Griffin Marshall tries to roll out, and number 8, Paul-Marie Dogui, nice through the middle. Dogui, the junior, nice through the middle of the offensive line and makes a big sack back to the 32-yard line, an 8-yard loss. Dogui, the Colgate commit. He'll be playing his football in the cold up in New York State next year. Great university.
Good pressure, good movement there.
Second and very long now. Second and 18 for the War Eagles. Marshall takes a shotgun snap. And he's hit again. And another loss in the backfield. And there's Dogui again in the middle of that. Alongside, see if we can see who else is coming out of the middle of that pack. Along with 78, Tramari Watkins. And now it's third and very, very long. Ball all the way back to the 28-yard line, and it's third down now on 22. A drive that started on the 40-yard line. Very promising field position for the War Eagles, but in two plays, they've been pushed all the way back inside their own 30. Third and very, very long. We'll see how Woodward wants to play this. What does Coach Hunt have in mind on third and very, very long? Shotgun snap coming back, looking. Defensive pressure coming off. Throws it out to the side, and it is incomplete. Intended out there for Lucas Farrington. The ball falls incomplete. Coach, that was very close to being a lateral, but ruled a forward pass and falls incomplete. Brings up fourth down now in 22. And once again, out to punt is Jonah Bloom, the senior.
Great job by the front. I mean, that was a four-man rush. And we didn't give him any time.
So very good defensive series there for the Blue Tornado. Chance to get perhaps a good field position. Different returner. I think that's Tabuto back there, 24. A little pressure on the punter. The ball's away. Lands inside the 40 and rolling sideways and down right there. And McCauley will have the ball now first and 10 at their own 40. And coach, a very close play there with the ball landing there. A couple of those McCauley guys were a little too close to that for my taste, but the ball kicks sideways. McCauley has it first down now, so
32 yard.
Thank you. I was trying to do the math, and no, it's our Jeff Romero's over here trying to give us the right information, and that was a little slow looking. And my apology to my high school math teacher, Mrs. Teitelbaum. I'm really sorry. Actually, I can do math, just not on the fly. So here we go. First and 10, McCauley coming out from the 40-yard line, leading 7-0, just under 9.5 minutes, 9:26 in the first half. As we expected, this has been a slugfest on the offensive and defensive fronts. Fake. Looking over the middle. Pass is complete. There's Carson Gentle. He's not down yet. Driving forward. Broke the initial tackle. They're trying to strip the ball away, and he is brought down at the 40-yard line, a 20-yard completion. A number of players in on the tackle for the War Eagles, including number 10, Andrew Hines, kind of leading the charge. But Gentle right down the seam. We saw a big play on that last year, 50-yard-plus play for McCauley. Big play there, now in plus territory, first and 10 at the War Eagles 40. Back, St. Hilaire looking, over the middle. There's McMahon. Shifty makes one man miss. And another first down. Brought down by Tyree Myrick, 12 yards on the play. McCauley, first down and 10 at the 28-yard line. Tempo was something Coach Bradford talked about, wanting to get the offensive tempo. And here we're seeing it. And certainly against a big, strong, powerful defensive line, you can see the effect of tempo. A number of the defensive linemen now hands on hips. And that's the look you want to see if you're on the offensive side of the ball. Big, strong, athletic guys trying to get them to move side to side. And tempo is part of that. Let's see if McCauley can keep the drive going against this talented defense of the War Eagles. St. Hilaire back, steps up in the pocket, looking over the middle. Tabuteau too high and incomplete. Had him. Tabuteau had a step on the defender. That was C.J. Hurd, the Florida State commit. Tabuteau had a step, or actually two steps on him, but the throw sails a little high, and it's going to be second down now for McCauley at the 28. So, Coach, big drive here for McCauley to try to cash this in with 8.5 minutes to go in the first half. St. Hilaire waiting for the shotgun snap. Four wide receivers. Pressure up, coming up the middle, perhaps, for the War Eagles. McMahon off the edge. Five, six, still going. Breaking tackle, still going. Another first down for McMahon down to the 14-yard line. A 14-yard run brought down by 47, Rocco Zarigenis. Clock stopped and a big play there on the ground for McCauley, Coach.
Yeah, he is powerful. He's got great leg strength, and he can run. And we saw it was evident right there.
Stoppage in play, a flag is down. Well, let's see what we've got here. The flag is down near where the tackle was made, and it's going to be coming back. So now we'll sort all this out. Unsportsmanlike conduct is the penalty, and that's a dead ball. That's just lack of discipline. Apparently something said or something happened after the end of the play. So the 14 yards on the run, 15 yards on the penalty, wipes out a great run there by Javon McMahon. Well, Coach,
it's still first down.
That's true. First down. You keep the first down. But we saw some penalties and some mistakes last week, and certainly Coach Potter wanted to see that cleaned up, and that's a mental error that's going to cost the Blue Tornado 15 yards. And now St. Hilaire under pressure, throwing deep down the middle to Carson Lawrence, and he's unable to connect. J.L.S. Hood, the senior, on the coverage for the War Eagles. Boy, Coach, that's...
They can put some pressure on you. And they got some guys that can cover you up, too. So,
yeah, St. Hilaire, not a run-first quarterback, but certainly
he can
use his feet, yeah, right, to get out of trouble, and you've certainly seen that happening so far tonight. Second down and 10 now from the 29-yard line. St. Hilaire back. Pressure off the edge. Merritt, and he is hit as he throws. And that's an incomplete pass. London Merritt coming off the backside, hit St. Hilaire right as he released the ball. And fortunately for McCauley, the arm was moving forward and it falls incomplete. Could have been a lot worse if Merritt had another half step.
Yeah, that was just a line mistake there. We turned somebody loose that we don't need to be turned loose. And you're right, another tenth of a second, that ball's on the ground, him scooping it up, scoring maybe.
Third down and 10 now for the War Eagles, 29-yard line. St. Hilaire waiting for the snap. Back looking. Here comes pressure down the sideline. Toward the middle on a post pattern is Nolan Sargent. The ball falls incomplete. And it's going to be fourth down and 10 now for the Blue Tornado at the 29-yard line. And here comes Elliot Arnold to attempt a long field goal of 46 yards from the right hash mark. McCauley getting into kicking formation. Nolan Sargent is going to be the holder. Snapper is 59, Nelson Williams. This is in range for Arnold. We've seen him hitting 50 to 55 in practice. And this kick is up. It's got the distance, and it is good.
Wow.
A solid 46-yard. Had another 10 yards in it, Coach. Big kick there. Yeah. Elliot Arnold getting some looks from colleges, and you see why. Steps into that one, hits a 46-yarder with room to spare.
Boy, that was impressive.
And so with 7:50 remaining in the first half here, second quarter action, McCauley takes a 10-0 lead. And if you're watching at home, my apologies for not keeping the quarter updated. It is the second quarter. That's my tactical mistake. Second quarter, 10-0 McCauley.
Well, the penalty hurt. You know, took us out of good field position and then kind of slowed us down a little bit with momentum. And
So disappointing not to potentially get seven, but at least you got three, right?
That's right.
Don't want to come away with nothing. And looks like we have another break for heat, apparently. I'm seeing the Woodward Academy players kneeling on the far side. So it looks like we could have a short break here. Very, very warm here tonight. And hot is the appropriate term. Hot and humid in Chattanooga today all day. There was a game on the turf at 4 o'clock today, which must have been brutally hot. And even now that the sun is down, it's still very, very warm and muggy.
Stuffy, yeah.
So we'll see throughout the course of the game how this may play. Are we going to be seeing cramps? We're going to see players in the second half having trouble. Obviously, you hope that's not the case. But that's the importance of the training staff, Jersey DeMarco, and the other guys who take care of our athletes. And certainly Woodward would have as excellent trainers as well, making sure the athletes are healthy, well hydrated, and ready to compete on a really hot night. Last week, about 80 degrees at kickoff. Cooled into the upper 70s. Later, it was a beautiful evening. Beautiful sunset tonight, but really hot.
That's the only positive.
Right? Yes, really hot. So, been hot all week in Chattanooga. Elliot Arnold tees it up again. Coming off the 46-yard field goal. 7:50 remaining in the second quarter. Arnold, the kick is up, and it's a little shorter. Heading toward the corner and bounces.
Oh, my goodness.
Apparently just out of bounds right before he reached the end zone. That's going to be a penalty against the Blue Tornado. So it looked like he was trying to perhaps keep the ball away from those deep men, but it just bounced out. Looked like it was probably inside the 1 yard line, but it's a penalty. And so instead of starting at the 20, the War Eagle started at the 35. First and 10 for Woodward, trailing 10-0, 7:50 remaining in the second quarter. Finley Stadium here in Chattanooga. The Border Wars rematch of last year's game on the same field that ended 17-13. Tonight, another relatively low-scoring affair for these two powerful offenses. And if you like offensive line and defensive line play, it's been a feast tonight for the fans. If you're a high-scoring fan, maybe not so much, but if you can appreciate the finer points and the physicality of football, you're seeing a lot of that tonight from both sides. Looks like a timeout taken by Woodward. So, Coach, when I talked to Coach Bradford, the offensive coordinator, earlier this week, he talked about the guys up front. Tremari Watkins up front, a new starter. You across the front, Watkins and Hodgkins Key and Bertiome and Kaufman and Camerlane. Kaufman, the only returning starter. And talked about the importance of these guys, really most of them learning new positions. So Watkins and Hodgkins Key both, he said they put their heads down. They were asked to take on new roles. They did. Last year, Camerlane had a big catch in this game as a tight end. This spring, they came to him and said, hey, can you put on some weight and move the tackle? He said, whatever you want. So great attitudes from these players. And now, baptism of fire right here against an incredibly talented War Eagles defensive front. So far, what do you think?
Well, it's the thing about Jaden, too, is he's playing.
Pause here for a deep pass down the sidelines that is intercepted. That's Deshaun Tipton on the pick, and that pass from Griffin Marshall was headed in the general direction of Josiah Abdullah, but not really close. So nice play by McCauley, by Tipton catching that ball over his shoulder, and it brings back out the McCauley offense, which you were just starting to talk about,
well,
Coach.
The tough thing is it's trying to stay out of second long and third and long, these guys are going to have, they're growing up every play. They're seeing something different every play and seeing some kind of movement every play, and they're running different plays. So it's just a matter of each play, as Coach would say, process and just execute, do their job, and then just try to.
Quick strike out to the side to Javon McMahon from Jay Saint-Hilaire. No gain. Back to the 30-yard line. In the middle of the pile there,
is 47.
For the defense, yes, Rocco Zarigenis and Miles Hakeem.
Those linemen got to be tough-minded, too, because they're going to make some mistakes. They're young. They're going to make some mistakes. They just got to, you know, line up and play again.
So McMahon now splits out far to the far side of the field. Five wide receivers. Four-man front for the War Eagles. St. Hilaire back looking across the middle. He connects with Ryan Larrabee, 22. Around the 50, here comes a block from Tabuto that springs in for about another 10 yards. And 22, Ryan Larrabee, all the way down to the 37-yard line.
Where they beat him inside. He beat that guy inside, and there's a bunch of space there.
32 yards on the big play.
Nice throwing catch.
From St. Hilaire to Ryan Larrabee, the junior, and it's McCauley now rolling again, trying to get some tempo going here, Coach, late in the second quarter, under 7 minutes, clock running, first and 10, McCauley. St. Hilaire back, looking out to the side. Carson Lawrence catches hit immediately and dropped by J. Ellis Hood. Short gain of about 4 yards. So you saw Lawrence split out this side by himself, one-on-one out there. Good throw, good catch, good tackle.
With the trips over there, the safety has to honor the number three receiver over there, so this corner's kind of on an island by himself. Sometimes he's been pressing some.
Shotgun snap, pressure coming off the edge. Out to the side, there's McMahon, and he's run out of bounds. There's Hood again in the center of the action, but a little swing pass, and that is enough for a first down for McCauley. The ball marked at the 26-yard line. So Hood on the tackle. Hood, the senior cornerback, 5'9", and Carson Lawrence, whom he's trying to cover, is, Coach, every bit of 6'3". So a tough matchup on this side of the field, but Hood so far has been up to the task. First and 10, McCauley at the 26-yard line. Shotgun snap coming to St. Hilaire. Fakes the handoff, looking. Toward the outside, the pass is just high and incomplete, wow. Intended for Hebert. Hebert turned his head, and the ball was almost on him. Left unable to make the catch. R.J. Harrison, number 3, was in coverage out there for the War Eagles. And that's a long throw, Coach, for a high school quarterback to make. Just the timing seemed like it was just a little bit off on that play, and the ball falls incomplete.
Well, it's a good thing it was high, too, because had it been thrown behind him, that DB might have run off with it. So.
Yeah, all these DBs can run, right? Everyone on the field who's wearing white tonight is fast, and so that's a very little margin for error. Second and 10. Nolan Sargent in motion. Here comes London Merritt up the middle. Dropping back, looking for Carson Gentle. He's tackled, and that's going to be pass interference. Tyree Myrick is the guilty party, but you saw there was London Merritt ruining people's nights, coming off the edge again. St. Hilaire let it go. Carson Gentle had a step and looked poised to potentially reel that ball in, and Myrick just tackled him from behind right on the goal line. 15-yard pass interference penalty gives the Blue Tornado first and 10 at the 13. But, Coach, if he doesn't make that tackle, probably a touchdown.
That's kind of what, you know, as a DB, that's kind of what you – if you're beat and it's a touchdown or a penalty, then you're taking the penalty.
6:04 remaining, second quarter. McCauley now first down and 10 at the 14-yard line of the War Eagles.
Either way, good for us.
Trying to stretch out this lead, which is currently 10 points. St. Hilaire, shotgun snap. Quarterback draw, spins out of one tackle, but not out of two. Eventually brought down by Myrick, but the initial play was made by number 50, Miles Hakeem, who knifed through, almost brought down St. Hilaire. He stepped out of the tackle, but completely stopped his forward momentum. And then Myrick was able to come in and clean things up. Loss of about 3 yards, it looks like. Second down and 13. Ball resting between the 16 and 17-yard lines. Maybe closer to the 16 from this angle. It's like LeClaire and Nolan Sargent to the far side.
Tell you what, they're not paying any attention to that Z.
Fake.
And there he goes.
St. Hilaire looking. Wide open is Sargent and incomplete.
Wow.
And, you can see that Jay St. Hilaire knows it. So the wheel route from Sargent, the second time we've seen that route tonight, Coach, and the second time it's fallen incomplete. And you were just saying, Coach, what were you just saying as the play started?
Yeah, well, the Z
is on the near side, correct?
Well, he's on the far side. He's the third receiver, and they're putting the linebacker on him if he releases. And that's the catch that Carson caught for the big play down here earlier in the first quarter.
So third down now and long for McCauley, looking fade route, heading toward Carson Lawrence in the corner of the end zone, incomplete.
Hitch and go.
And R.J. Harrison again out there on the coverage. Is that the pass may have been a little flat because you got 6 inches on the DB out there, but maybe not quite enough air under it for Carson Lawrence, unable to come down with it. And so now it's going to be fourth down and 13. Here comes Elliot Arnold to attempt another field goal, marked at the 23. It'll be a 33-yard attempt from the right hash. Sargent is the holder. A little bit of a high snap. He gets it down. The kick is up, and it is. Oh, it's good by a long shot.
Not a baby.
Nelson Williams is the snapper. Nolan Sargent is the holder. And Elliot Arnold is the kicker, and plenty of distance and plenty of leg on that. Stretches out the McCauley lead now. Late stages of the second quarter. Clock is at 5:07. 13-0 McCauley with the lead over the War Eagles from Woodward Academy.
You know, Woodward plays a lot of people on defense up front. They rotate it about seven different guys because they're also playing offense. And so, maybe we can wear them down. We get good stops defensively, and offense is getting some good drives and keeping them out on the field. So,
you see, with some McCauley, you see Tremari Watkins and Jaden Hudgens Key. Some those guys play some both ways, right?
But they alternate with each other. So that on defense they alternate with each other. I think so that helps there. But for the most part, I think they're the only two there.
So big drive there. McCauley cashes in for three. So 5:07. But as you're saying, Coach, the second half we're going to see fatigue on the front line or on the field in general with the heat and humidity. We're going to see that potentially play a part in the second half.
Yes.
And obviously, again, you hope a player on either side never has to leave the game because of a physical issue like that. But the reality is on a hot, humid night, that can happen. So cramping, we'll see how that plays out. None of that so far as we can tell. Fortunately, again, for all these athletes, Elliot Arnold on to kick off from the 40-yard line. Last time the kick bounced out of bounds at around the 1 or 2-yard line came out to the 35. I'm sure that is not what Coach Potter's hoping will happen this time. Ball falls off the tee. Arnold resets. Lots of speed back there waiting deep for the War Eagles. Arnold will definitely try to put this ball in the end zone if he can. He got his foot into it, and that is going to be deep and almost out of the back of the end zone. So that's the Elliot Arnold we saw last week.
Yeah, but I tell you what, starting on that 20-yard line, there's nothing better. Or unless you kick it really high and tackle them inside the 20 every now and then. But
even with this speed, you'd rather see them.
It's better to go in the end zone.
And again, I want to give a shout out to the all-name team. This kid should be an all-name All-American. He's the guy who retrieves the kickoff tee for us. He's a freshman, number 83, Ezra Centurion. Just love that name, so shout out to the Centurion family. It's a great football name. And here we go, first down and 10 now. Fake handoff, quarterback keep, nothing doing. And a flag comes in late. Carson Gentle was in there, as was Phil Buto, and a flag comes late. Waiting for the indication. No gain on the play. Face mask coming against the Blue Tornado.
Wow.
But that's an unfortunate penalty in any situation, but especially when you have the play stopped, although we saw that happen on the other side of the ball earlier in this quarter. But McCauley right up in the middle had the play stopped. Someone grabbed the face mask, and it's 15 yards out to the 35-yard line. Clock running, or clock at 5:02. Woodward Academy with two first downs in the game so far, Coach. So McCauley defense has been very effective for the first quarter and a half. 4:46 clock running second quarter. Shotgun snap back, looking over the middle. There's Grice wide open, running free. Tackled after a gain of about 13 out to the 44-yard line. Marshall to Ben Grice. Senior wide receiver across the middle. And let's see if the War Eagles offense can get going, trailing by 13, under 4.5 minutes in the first half.
That's two plays in a row, the penalty and then that one. Can't let them get momentum.
That's 27 yards on two plays between the 15 of the penalty and the completion, and now here come the War Eagles again. Three receivers to the near side of the field. Shotgun snap. Fake handoff. Quarterback keeper tripped up. Carson Gentle, the Tennessee commit, trips him up for no gain.
Carson's having him a big night so far.
And Griffin Marshall, second time we've seen that quarterback keeper on this drive, and nothing doing thanks to the play by Gentle. Senior wearing that special number 17 number for McCauley, and maybe we'll come back to that in the second half. That's a special honor for a McCauley player, and this year it's Carson Gentle who wears it. Second down and 10, three receivers to the far side for the War Eagles. Shotgun snap, rolling to the right, some pressure from the inside, out to the ball thrown to the side and complete. Short gain.
Yeah.
Josiah Abdullah makes the catch, gain the 4 yards. We'll bring up third down and 6. And you talked earlier, Coach, about Griffin Marshall being effective on the move, and there was another one of those rollout plays looking in the flat. Abdullah makes a catch, unable to advance the ball. Brings up third down and medium, third and 6.
We got in his face pretty fast, so he probably threw that ball a little bit sooner than he wanted to.
Looked like he went maybe through the hands of one of the McCauley defenders.
Yep.
Under 2 minutes, 2:50, clock running, second quarter. Third down for the War Eagles. Three receivers to the near side once again. Clock is stopped, and that's going to be a timeout.
They've called timeout.
That's the second timeout taken by the War Eagles. Leaves them with one. 2:42. Clock is stopped. Big play here.
Yeah, this is a big play.
Trailing 13-0. You'll often hear coaches and commentators talk about the last 4 minutes of the first half and the first 4 minutes of the second half. As a reminder, the War Eagles had the ball first, so McCauley gets the ball coming out of halftime. So probably a big time here for the War Eagles to try to get some points so McCauley can't push that lead out beyond two scores.
Yeah, that's right. This is a big play for them. They had a little momentum there and didn't get the throw probably that they wanted to get and make it 3rd and 7, 3rd and 6. So their coaches, I'm sure he called timeout to make sure they got the best play they can get to see if they can't keep this drive. And, of course, Coach Potter's going to match that defense and try to make them punt the ball. Coach, we do a lot of things on defense. So we're 3-man front, we're 4-man front, we're 50 look, we're pressure, play quarters, we play man. So and coaches does a great job of mixing that stuff up. And he even calling it the line of scrimmage to make sure that he's putting these kids in the best position they can be successful.
Third down now. Here comes the War Eagles offense. Coach, big play here for the McCauley defense. Big play for the Woodward offense. 3rd and 6 from the 48. Three receivers to the near side. One to the far side. Back, looking. Down the middle. The receiver falls down. The ball is intercepted again by Deshaun Tipton. He's coming up the right side. He's got a little bit of room. He breaks one tackle. He's brought down. That's an offensive lineman, 77. Caron Houston makes the stop. But Josiah Abdullah, look like he was the intended receiver. And, Coach, I think he just fell down. And 32 yards on the return for Tupton.
I don't know that they had anything had he not fallen down. But
So an easy interception, as it turns out, as Marshall, as Abdullah goes down, Tupton makes the pick for McCauley. And now the Blue Tornado, with 2:30 remaining in the first half, have the ball heading back the other direction. So Tupton's a sophomore, and he's already had a couple of big plays this year on the McCauley defense. And the Blue Tornado faithful will definitely see him on the basketball court, a very talented basketball player as well. McCauley comes out first and 10 in plus territory at the 40-yard line. St. Hilaire back, stepping up in the pocket, looking down the sidelines to Enrique James LeClaire, and it's just a little too long.
Tell you what, he could run right there. They rushed that. They rushed and got him all upfield. He steps up. He kind of made him some yards if he had just pulled it and ran. But he thought he had him beat down there. So
LeClaire goes deep. Hood in coverage again on the near side of the field. The ball just a little too long, and now it's second down. So that's a kind of the case of getting the turnover in plus territory and taking the shot, which you often see coaches do. Coach Bradford, the offensive coordinator, pulled the trigger on that pass play, unable to complete. And attempted quarterback draw to the left, and he's not going anywhere. London Merritt wreaking havoc in the backfield. You saw St. Hilaire come out, nothing there. Tried to cut it up, slipped. And Merritt there to make the stop, third down and 14. Coach, I'm not sure I'd be running the ball his direction.
They get pretty good edges.
That's true. Both sides are pretty good. On the other side, you've got 44. Aiden Hughes has been on a lot of plays as well. So you're right. You've got two bad choices there if you're the McCauley offense. Correction, the far side now. Defensive end is, that's 50. Miles Hakeem, back to pass, throwing incomplete. St. Hilaire hit in the backfield by Amari Irvin. Ball falls to the turf. And it's fourth down and 14 for McCauley. So big interception by Tupton. Takes the ball back down inside the War Eagles territory. You think there may be a chance for McCauley to push out the lead a little more going into halftime. But the defense rises up. McCauley goes backwards, and now it's going to be fourth down. LeClaire will punt. Josiah Abdullah waits at about the 10-yard line. 1:36 remaining in the second quarter. McCauley leading 13-0. You saw the signal coming in from the sidelines from the War Eagles. Don't touch it. Just stay away from it. Here's the kick. Abdullah got dangerously close. And the ball bounds into the end zone. Come out to the 20-yard line with 1:29 remaining.
Got to go 80 in a minute 29.
Yeah, one timeout left for Woodward. Boy, Coach, if you tell your return man to stay away from it, that's pretty close. But ball takes some funny turns, sometimes off the hop, but the ball goes in the end zone. And first and 10 now for Woodward. Griffin Marshall leads them out on the field. Players rushing on and off the field. Gryson Abdullah to the near side. Very dangerous. Now shifting into five wide receiver formation. Marshall alone back, looking out to the right. Short pass is complete to number 10, Andrew Hines, and he's brought down immediately. Good tackle, Carson Gentle in on the play. Gain of about 4 yards. Clock running, 1:13. One timeout left for Woodward. Second down and 4. Back in the huddle at this point, Coach, you wonder, at this point, they don't seem to be in a hurry. Perhaps that short gain on first down is going to cause them to play a little more conservative. We'll see.
Be interesting after this play.
If McCauley calls a timeout, you're saying, depending on what happens here?
Yep.
Okay, second down now and 6. Shotgun snap, back, looking. Down the right side, he's wide open, but overthrown.
Wow. We got a break there.
Jerome Bettis Jr. had broken past the defense. Marcellus Barnes Jr., the Virginia Tech commit, and Carson Lawrence, the Vanderbilt commit. And Bettis just ran right between them. As you say, a break for the Blue Tornado. Pass falls incomplete. 45 seconds. Clock stops. Now 3rd and 6. McCauley with all 3 timeouts left. So if the Blue Tornado can make a stop here, let's see what Coach Potter has in mind about potentially trying to get the ball back. We've seen Arnold already make a 46-yard field goal. Could McCauley try to score again before halftime? Let's see what happens on 3rd down and 6. Shotgun snap, back, looking. Out to the side, behind Abdullah. And it falls incomplete. Fourth down, Josiah Abdullah coming out of the near flat. The pass from Marshall was behind him. Abdullah tried to spin around and make a one-handed, very athletic play. The ball falls incomplete.
Now we got 41 seconds.
And Jonah Bloom will punt. 41 seconds, as you say, Coach. The ball resting on the 24-yard line. 24 is Keyshawn Tabuteau back deep for McCauley. Let's see what kind of return we might get, Coach, and then we'll see how Coach Potter, again, knowing McCauley gets the ball to start the third quarter, we'll see how he plays it. The kick is up and almost blocked. Hits at the 50, bounding.
Ooh.
Just inside the 40. It rolls. The clock rolls. The ball is down at the 38-yard line. A little pushing and shoving on the near side of the field.
38-yard punt.
38 yards on the kick. First and 10, McCauley. 30 seconds to go. All the timeouts left. You're up 13 points. You get the ball coming out in the second half. One timeout left for Woodward. Coach, what's your strategy here? Are you just going to try to go in the locker room up 13, or are you going to try to get some more points?
I think we'd try to get some more points here. I mean, we got pretty good field position, and with all our timeouts.
Is this one of those situations where you run a short passing play, and if you get some yards, yeah, then you keep going, and if not, then you kind of shut it down?
The first play is the key here, I think.
Three wide receivers to the far side, one to the near side. St. Hilaire looks over to Joel, the Coach Bradford. Joel Bradford gives the call. Here comes the pressure, St. Hilaire. Slant pattern to James LeClaire is knocked down. J. Ellis Hood in the middle of the action again. Second down and 10 for McCauley at the 38-yard line.
Well, now they're coming after us pretty good, so got to be able to protect that ball.
5 wide receivers now for McCauley. Nobody back there with the quarterback, St. Hilaire. Pressure coming. Flag is down. I think McCauley moved early. It is indeed illegal motion. I think we can credit Rocco Zarigenis, who was showing blitz up the middle. I think that got the offensive lineman a little jumpy. And now it's second and very long for McCauley. Second down and 15. 21 seconds remaining. And I'm assuming at this point we're going to see Coach Potter be very conservative with the play calls.
Yeah.
St. Hilaire back looking. Pressure up the middle. He's going to tuck it and get sacked for a loss of about 3 yards.
I'd say they're going to let that clock run.
15 seconds clock running.
The slant down here was a good call. Corner just made a great play.
And
Woodward
will not use their final timeout, and McCauley will not use any of theirs, and the clock's going to run out. So, at halftime, it's McCauley 13, Woodward nothing. We got a 15-minute halftime, plus then a 3-minute warm-up period. So we're 18 minutes away from football action starting here again. So, Coach, what are your big takeaways from the first half in this game tonight?
Well, the penalties a little bit hurt both teams, and we took advantage of some opportunities and them kind of shooting themselves in the foot with drop passes early, you know, missed passes late. But defensively, we're getting after him, and we're forcing him to make some throws, some bad throws. And offensively, you know, we've done some things, really good things with running the football and have missed some opportunities ourselves, you know, when throwing games. So go in the locker room, clean some of that stuff up. We get the ball. We're up 13. We get the ball against a good football team here. So, you know, that it's always the first 5 minutes of the second half is the kind of the key. You got a little momentum. You want to keep it. I'm not sure who's got the momentum right now. So I think it's kind of even. So we got to kind of come back out in the second half and establish ourselves offensively. And they'll do a great job of making some adjustments in there. They've given Woodward Academy a bunch of different looks formation-wise. They'll see what they've been getting defensively. Joel and Mike and those guys will make some great adjustments. And defensively, we've been doing some good stuff. So
Yeah, so kind of panning our cameraman here. I'm going to get this wrong. Jonah Nolan?
Lance Nolan.
Lance Nolan, my apologies. I know I had, because Nolan's also a first name, and I was confused. Lance Nolan up here with us tonight, folks. I think this is the first time he's worked with us, right? Coming into Finley Stadium and has done a tremendous job for us here in the first half. Great to have him here. And as you just saw him panning through, you saw the band now beginning to disperse, but a really good student section out here tonight. It's beach night, apparently.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so my son, who's a junior, came to me 1 minute before I had to leave the house, and he said, "Dad, do you have a Hawaiian shirt?" And, of course, I did. You know, I had a Hawaiian shirt I got in Hawaii. So, and my daughter's out here tonight. They're all in beach attire, so a fun evening and very appropriate on a hot night like this. So a good turnout tonight from Macaulay. You see, in a big stadium like this, it can be a little deceiving. There's actually a pretty good crowd here tonight. And even up into the box seats up closer to where we are in the press box, pretty good turnout tonight. And a good turnout, again, from Woodward as well, our guest from Atlanta. And I guess if you told Coach Potter tonight you're going to go into the locker room with a 13-point lead, he would probably take that.
I think he'd probably take that. You're right.
So we're going to take a short break. And we'll be back in time for the second half. Macaulay 13, Woodward Academy nothing. David Eastman, Coach Rick Witt, we'll be right back with you in a few moments for the start of the second half. Welcome back here to Finley Stadium. A few minutes away from the start of the second half. McCauley with a 13-0 lead. So I want to welcome again all the McCauley faithful watching tonight wherever you are. And, of course, welcome any of our guests from Woodward Academy in Atlanta who might be watching. Hope you're enjoying tonight's broadcast. And we are glad to bring it to you. David Eastman here along with Coach Rick Witt. Lance Nolan is on the camera. And Jeff Romero is up in the booth feeding us good information. So if bad information comes out, it's not his fault. It's my fault. So thanks to Jeff for being here. And we have some first half stats for you folks. In the first half, McCauley had 11 first downs on offense, 3 for the War Eagles. On third down, McCauley was 2 for 6, and Woodward was 0 for 6. Penalties, Woodward had 3 penalties for 33 yards. McCauley, 7 penalties for 70 yards. Coach Witt talked right before halftime, right as halftime started, about the penalties. 70 yards in penalties in the first half for McCauley. Rushing yards for Woodward, 8 yards on 6 attempts. And for McCauley, 16 rushes and 41 yards. Quarterbacks, Jay St. Hilaire for McCauley, 11 for 20 with 156 yards. Javon McMahon, the leading rusher, 36 yards on the night. For Woodward Academy, quarterback Griffin Marshall, 6 for 15 with 62 yards passing, a couple of interceptions. And as we saw in the first half, some of those incompletions were just flat-out drops, so we'll see if they can get their passing game going in the second half. It could be a tight second half here as we look forward to these teams locking horns. We've talked about the physicality of the game. We'll see how the physicality plays out in the second half. So a few things for McCauley faithful, a few things to share about Woodward. I met today with my colleague and a proud Woodward alum, Jim Suddeth, in the Bible department of McCauley. So Woodward's founded in 1900 as a Georgia military academy. And in the late 60s, it became a private co-ed institution. And several sources I found say that it's the largest private school in the country. So something there to take note of. A boarding school until the early 90s, and now is 100% day students. And apparently the most famous alum is a guy named Robert Woodruff, after whom the Atlanta Fine Arts Center is named, who back in the early 20th century dropped out of Emory after a year and bought a little fledgling local soda company and turned it into the Coca-Cola company. So that's a good investment.
That's interesting news, right?
That worked
there
out well for him. So Jim Suddeth, again, working in the Bible department of McCauley, proud alum of Woodward, basketball player there back in the late 70s, and in the Woodward Academy Hall of Fame. So Coach Suddeth, I think, is maybe watching the game from back in Presley this evening. And a lot of famous people have sent their kids to Woodward. Hank Aaron's daughters went there. President Carter sent his daughter there. So a long, illustrious, and then, of course, Jim Suddeth went there. So a long, illustrious list of students there at the Woodward Academy in Atlanta. And obviously a great matchup to see them here with McCauley. Two great programs, very ranked in the top 10 in the state of Georgia. McCauley, highly ranked in Tennessee, and we are underway in the second half with a kick that goes into the end zone, and that's going to be a touchback. So McCauley will come out first down and 10. Leading 13-0, looking to stretch out this lead, perhaps here early in the third quarter.
Need a good start here. I tell you what, you hold this group to 8 yards rushing first half. You've done some good stuff.
So here comes McCauley now with a 13-0 lead, just underway here, start of the third quarter. Jay St. Hilaire with McMahon in the backfield, Carson Gentle there. 24 Keyshawn Tabuteau in the backfield, right next to LeClaire, or correction, right next to St. Hilaire. Shotgun snap, option play to the right. Tabuteau off the edge. He's got some room. Cut off the block from McMahon. One man to beat. He's shifting and continuing down the field. And he's going to be brought down at the 45-yard line. That's a 35-yard run.
I was wondering when we were going to start that double option.
I think that was J.L.S. Hood who's finally made the play for the War Eagles, but the first play coming out, Coach, you saw Tabuteau go in the backfield, caught your attention, good speed on the edge, and that little option play, speed option to the right, works to great effect. Now Tabatou comes near side. St. Hilaire in the backfield with McMahon. Correction, 34 yards, marked at the 46, right up the gut, St. Hilaire. So same similar look with the option look to the right. He cuts it up the middle, and we have a flag down. We'll see if this is going to come back. The flag is thrown right in the middle of the play, which we'll see what the call is. Downfield about 4 yards.
That's a great job running the option in the second half because you run it in the first half, and they're trying to make some adjustments to it.
Personal foul is a face mask on the offense.
Oh, wow.
So must have been in the middle of that scrum on the blocking scenario there. 15-yard penalty, and we talked about it. 70 yards of penalties in the first half. The first drive of the second half, 15 more yards added to that. And the ball comes all the way back to the McCauley 43-yard line, where it's going to be first and about, looks like 21 if my math is true. Shotgun snap for St. Hilaire. A man off the right side. He's got some room. One man to beat if he can get around. Stiff arm. Pushed out of bounds by R.J. Harrison. From the 43, he got out to about the 48, so 5 yards on the play. It's going to bring up second down and 16. The ball resting at the McCauley 48-yard line. Clock running, or correction, clock stopped. 11:07, third quarter. Here comes McCauley now. LeClaire and Sargent to the near side. Matthew Hebert goes to the far side of the field. Shotgun snap.
Got him moving around.
Looking. There's Sargent. Intercepted. Oh, incomplete. Almost intercepted on the near side of the field by Tyree Myrick. So, Coach, we've seen that wheel route run a couple times, of variations of it tonight. With Nolan Sargent, looked like McCauley went back to that again, and that time the War Eagles defense was ready for it.
Adjustment, yeah.
And just bobbled by Myrick on the near side of the field, unable to gain control before he went out of bounds. So a bit of a break there for McCauley.
Yep.
Third down now, still third and long for McCauley. The ball almost to midfield. 11 minutes to go in the third quarter. So Jim Setta tells me the name War Eagles does go back to a connection with Auburn, to the Auburn War Eagle mascot. But, well, after this play, we'll say finish that thought. Right at the middle, London Merritt. The pass is thrown out to the side and intended for Hebert, but falls incomplete. Jay St. Hilaire gets up off the ground, and Hebert was wide open out there for potential first down play, but Merritt again right in the face of the quarterback, and the ball falls incomplete. So Auburn's mascot is the inspiration for the name War Eagles. However, they're apparently the home football field for a long time resembled a mini version of the Georgia football facility with the hedges. So there's a little strange SEC mixture there. Yeah, McCauley's going to punt. Movement on the near side, and is a flag. Correction, on the far side of the field, that's the gunner, 19 David Yancey, who flinched before the snap. And McCauley will be moved back 5 yards and line up the punt again. It was 4th and 16. It's now going to be 4th and 21. So they mark off the penalty. 10:47. So McCauley comes out with some initial fire in the second half on offense, but a big penalty. The face mask penalty pushed them back and really took them out of that drive.
Yep.
And now here they are punting. 4th and very long. LeClaire back to punt. Kick is away. Good kick. Good spiraling kick. At the 10, goes straight up in the air and rolling inside the 5 and down. Well, let's see. It's a touchback.
Wow.
Oh, a tough break from McCauley. Great kick. Went straight up in the air at the 10-yard line, rolling toward the goal line. And I think that's R.J. Washington, number 13, who was down there as a gunner at the 1-yard line.
57 yards.
And right there, and the ball just squirted out of his hands across the goal line. Instead of being at the 1, The War Eagles will come out to the 20-yard line, first and 10 with 10:37 in the third quarter.
If we can throw that deep out, because they're playing soft corners all the time, we're going to start getting some – we'll start making some moving the football.
Here comes Woodward. Grice in motion on the far side of the field. Rolling out to the right. Pressure in his face. The throw is incomplete, intended for Abdullah. So Marshall with the fake handoff rolling out to the right. And there was a McCauley defender right in his face. That was Phil Buteau putting the pressure right in the face of the quarterback, Marshall. Marshall kind of threw off his back foot, probably a little quicker than he wanted to.
Because he had Merritt in the middle, too. So the great pressure helped us there.
Incomplete, second down and 10 for the War Eagles. Clock stopped, 10:32, third quarter. Andrew Hines comes on late, number 10. Grice in the slot to the near side. Abdullah is the split to the near side of the field. Shotgun snap, a little bit of movement. Flag.
Too much time, looks
and
like.
And you're correct. The play clock had run out. And looked like movement before the snap as well. Probably players who were itching to get going. The ball not snapped in time, and that put back 5 yards. Brings up second down and 15 for the War Eagles. So second game of the year for both teams, and still more penalties certainly than these coaches want to see. 85 yards in penalties for McCauley to this point. And if my math is correct, that's probably 38, I think, for the War Eagles. I get the thumbs up from Jeff Romero, so 33 plus 5 is 38, and I'm rolling tonight. Second down. Pressure, and he is going down. Griffin Marshall brought down in the backfield, and that's number 6, Chosen Lukombe. A very talented, had a lot of big plays last year, the senior defensive back from McCauley, a lot of big plays last year, making his presence felt there. And that's going to bring up a third down and 20 for the War Eagles, the ball resting at around their 10-yard line. Big play there by Lukombe off the edge. And now 5 wide receivers. Again, all of them very talented, all of them very fast. Third and long, but McCauley cannot fall asleep here on this big play. Low snap. Quarterback picks it up on the run. Lots of pressure. Reverses field. Looking. He's going to let it go near sideline and out of bounds. So McCauley had a couple shots at him in the end zone, but good athleticism by Griffin Marshall to escape the rush. Manages to throw the ball out of bounds safely. No interception. Really, no receivers were open on that play. That play kind of got knocked off kilter early, Coach.
Yeah, that was a great three-man rush. And what we do is we're rushing inside the tackles, trying to put pressure, trying to push the pocket, and get him outside the pocket. And then the middle linebacker is the guy that's kind of the second contained guy.
Jonah Bloom standing in his own end zone. Good snap. Mild pressure off the edge. Good kick. Landing at the 45, bouncing into McCauley territory. So from the 10-yard line down to the 44, that's a 46-yard kick.
That's a great job defensively.
So McCauley, and there's a late flag on the far side of the field. The official was about 10 yards from the sideline of Woodward Academy. He was facing the Woodward bench when a flag came out. So right now the ball is marked at the 44 of the Blue Tornado. They are supposed to take possession with 9:27 remaining third quarter. But let's see what the call is. Unsportsmanlike conduct. And again, I'm not clear exactly who it was, but the official was really right along the side of the numbers there. So about 10 yards from the sideline, was facing the Woodward bench. And the flag came out well after the play was over, so apparently something was said. From the sideline, from the Woodward sideline. That's going to be a big 15-yard penalty. And both teams really shooting themselves in the foot tonight, Coach, not just with penalties, but some big penalties, the 15-yarders on both sides. And so instead of having the ball at their own 44, McCauley now has the ball
at the
41.
Yep.
McCauley with a chance here to go up by three scores. 9:27 third quarter. Again, we don't know exactly what happened. The flag was thrown, and it's now McCauley ball at the 41 of the War Eagles. St. Hilaire waiting for the snap. Fakes it. That's Carson Gentle in the flat, but he's hit immediately and dropped for a loss of a yard. Number six, Tyree Myrick. So good, quick little completion to Carson Gentle, but Myrick got him down before Gentle could get his momentum going. Loss of 2 yards on the play. Brings up second down and 12. LeClaire to the near side. Hebert to the far side. Two men in the backfield now with the quarterback. Snap, fake handoff. It's the option this way. And St. Hilaire cuts it inside, spinning and getting a short gain. And the player is down for the War Eagles, grabbing his knee and now kind of punching the ground. Obviously, we hope this is not anything severe. Actually, two players down on the play for the War Eagles.
Cramp.
You can see the one player certainly appears to be a cramp. The trainers are trying to stretch him out. And let's hope we have three players down now on the field for the War Eagles. And obviously we hope none of these is a serious injury of any type. The one who is at the 45-yard line, I can't see the number, right in the middle of the field, it concerns me because he grabbed his knee first before he went down. But, again, hopefully it's nothing more than a cramp. So one of the players who's up and walking off the field is Andrew Hines, number 10. He was down momentarily. You see him walking gingerly toward the sideline. They were stretching him out. He's probably a cramp.
He's a two-way player, so.
The player who's down in the middle of the field is, that's 47.
The Mike linebacker, yeah.
Rocco Zarigenis, and again, we hope that's nothing more serious than maybe just a momentary lapse. Boy, let's hope for the best for number 47. Obviously, even if you're a McCauley fan, you don't want to see players get hurt, players get injured. So let's hope there's nothing serious. Good ovation here from the crowd. One more player is still down getting attention for cramps. I can't see his number. I apologize. Another one of the Woodward players is down, and it's a factor we talked about in the first half, Coach, with the heat and humidity. It's still very, very warm here tonight in Chattanooga. Now he's up and moving around. Oh, that's London Merritt. The big defensive end and tight end. Critical player. Now the question is, I was wondering, and here's the answer, they're making him leave the field. I guess all the players who went down have to be off the field for at least one play. But it's third and long for McCauley. The ball resting at the 48-yard line, so a lot of activity there. We're back to it, 8:42, third quarter. Clock running now, third and long for McCauley. Reverse, Nolan Sargent coming around the side. He's got two. Oh, it's a pass. Wide open, Enrique James LeClaire. Touchdown, Blue Tornado. 43 yards. You saw the reverse to Nolan Sargent. Nolan Sargent, the Belmont University baseball commit. And he came around on that reverse, and I thought, he's got two men right in front of him. Well, he had two men in front of him because they had let James Enrique LeClaire.
What a great call.
And Ricky James LeClaire go free down the sidelines. Sargent hits him, and it's a McCauley touchdown. Big strike to go up now 19-0 with 8:28 remaining in the third quarter. Arnold on to attempt the extra point. Up and good. Well, Coach, that's talk about calling the right play at the right time.
Yeah, that was
right,
something.
Third and long. McCauley started you look like the option action to the near side of the field. Sargent comes around in the reverse. And then Enrique James LeClaire was running wide open down the far side of the field. Sargent hits him. At that point, you just hope that the wide receiver is not so wide open that he drops it, right? Which you see a lot, right?
We throws
see
it out of bounds.
So,
for
McCauley, big strike there to take a 20-0 lead with 8.5 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. So a great call there by Coach Bradford, Coach.
Great call. And that kid took his eyes off the wide out, and there we are, 20-0.
So, folks, just looking, according to my weather app here, it's still 88 degrees in Chattanooga right now, and still very, very humid. So we saw a few minutes ago during that last timeout, several players off the field with cramps. Still a long way to go here. 8:28 remaining in the third quarter. A lot of football left to be played. So a good play from McCauley, but certainly way too early to begin packing in or backing off. So much talent, so much speed on the field for Woodward. Low line kick, line drive kick, fielded by Abdullah at the one. Knifing up to the 20 and to the 23-yard line. Good play there in the middle of the field. Let's pick up the number. McCauley stopped by 32. That's Bear Cortez.
Josiah
Cortez, the junior. So return out to the 19-yard line. 18 yards on the return for Abdullah. And here come the War Eagles trailing 20 to nothing. 8:22 now remaining in the third quarter. I think as we've counted it, the War Eagles have only been across midfield perhaps one time all night. So it's been a good night thus far for the McCauley defense, but a long way to go. Shotgun snap. Fake handoff on the keeper and nothing doing. In fact, probably a loss of a couple of yards for Griffin Marshall. And that was Paul Marie Dugui, the Colgate commit. Not fooled. Makes the play in the backfield. Ball marked down at the 16-yard line. Loss of 3, second down and 13. So Dugui plays some tight end, but really has entrenched himself firmly on the defensive line this year for the Blue Tornado. That looks to be his future at the next level as well. Shotgun formation. 4 wide receivers. Now 5 for the War Eagles. Back looking. No pressure across the middle. There's Grice. He's got it at the 40. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. He makes a cutback. He is going to go all the way.
Wow.
I don't think Tupton's going to catch him. And it is a Woodward touchdown. 84 yards.
That was a great throw and catch. I mean, there was some space in there, but we had a guy right around him.
Yeah, Griffin Marshall to Ben Grice, and we talked about Grice last year, had a big game against McCauley, and just for saying, a lot of speed on that side of the ball, and there it is, lightning strike, and all of a sudden it's 20-6. Now here comes the extra point team for Woodward. It's like the holder is the punter, Jonah Bloom. An extra point handled by Hudson Hangus, the senior, number 88. Woodward on to attempt the extra point to draw within 13 points. 7:22 in the third quarter. Just like that, Woodward is on the board. The kick is good. Well, Coach, Woodward comes out trailing by 20 points. Good defensive play on first down from McCauley. And then the lightning strike across the middle. And you can see Grice breaking free across the middle. And then after that, he's weaving down the field, a good block down the field by one of his colleagues. And great speed from that slot position and difficult for McCauley to handle in that situation.
Yeah, and, you know, no leads safe with this bunch because they are so athletic and can run, and so can we. But something like that can kind of change the momentum a little bit too.
So what's the message? You've got the team on the sideline after the extra point. You've got 20 seconds with your guys, Coach, before they're going back out. What's the message? Or maybe now as the coaches are talking to the offensive players, what's the message to your team after a lightning strike like that?
Well, you go back out and you do the things that you've been doing, you know, don't get all excited. Don't just, you know, Joe will make some good calls, plays, and play calls, and guys just keep making plays.
We've had an exciting
couple.
Keep
moving the chains is what you'd like to do.
All right,
keep moving the chains.
Shorten the game at this point.
Yeah.
And okay. Well, we had the reverse pass, Sargent to DeClaire, and then just a few minutes later, we had the long pass from Marshall to Grice. So after really a hard-fought defensive battle, we've had a couple of long plays here within a few minutes. And here's the kick. It's going to be fielded by McCauley. That's LeClaire, I think, at the 5. 15, 20, looking for room. Brought down out near the 25, looks like maybe the 24-yard line. And the tackle trying to pick up the player's number. That is number 6, Tyree Myrick, who's limping a little bit. You wonder if he's going to be another victim of this cramping issue that we've seen already from several players tonight for Woodward. You see, he just doesn't look comfortable moving on the field. So if you're an offensive coach, do you see that? And does that influence your play calls, Coach?
It could, yes, no doubt, particularly if he's lined up on a wideout.
Here he's guarding. He's coming over to the far side of the field. We'll see how Coach Bradford plays it. Shotgun snap coming. Fake handoff. Quick out to the side. Tabuteau on the catch. Nice cut inside. Makes one man miss. Spinning for 11 yards and a McCauley first down. Quick strike out to Keyshawn Tabuteau.
There's a player making a play right there.
Yeah, he looked like he was caught dead to rights, Coach, for no gain or maybe a loss, but he makes one man miss and then spins his way down for 11 yards and a coming off that long touchdown play from Woodward, getting a first down, big for McCullough. The clock running now 7 minutes in the third quarter and running. Tabuteau in the slot to the near side next to Hebert. Hand off at the middle. There's McMahon. Finding room, spinning. It's got about 8-7 yards. Stopped after a good gain on first down. 57, Johnny Okolo in on the stop in the middle of that defense. Second down and 3, so good first down play. Looks like some fireworks in the distance coming from the direction of AT&T Field. So probably sounds like the Lookouts game is over tonight on a Friday night. Great Chattanooga Lookouts tradition, the Friday night fireworks. And a hand up the middle, and there's London Barrett. He was struggling with cramps a few minutes ago, but not on that play, Coach. Merritt slices through and hits McMahon in the backfield for a loss. It's going to bring up 3rd down and 6. For McCauley, clock running under 6 minutes now in the third quarter. So, Coach, fireworks are going off in the distance, and I'm fighting that that insatiable announcer's urge to make some witty comment about, you know, McCauley can having fireworks, but I didn't say that, Coach. And then I just ruined it by saying that I didn't say it. See what I did there? I just can't. I need to learn when to stop
maybe
talking,
maybe you'll
right?
get to say it here in just a second.
That's right, yeah. Quit when you're ahead, Eastman. That's the motto for the night. All right, shotgun snap, 3rd and 6. St. Hilaire back. Look, he's got a man wide open. It's Tabuteau. Uncovered down the field to 30. He slips, making a cut. Another huge play for McCauley on 3rd and long. The ball's down to the 23-yard line. Bust in coverage there. And you can see R.J. Harrison looking at the safety and kind of giving him the what's going on. It was Harrison and C.J. Hurd looking at each other wondering who was supposed to have the coverage on that play. Nobody did, and it's 37 yards from McCauley down to the 23-yard line. So busting coverage, McCauley takes advantage with a long pass play. 5 minutes remaining, third quarter. Chance here, Coach, for McCauley to get that 7 points back.
Yep. Get that momentum
back. Fake rolling out left. Lots of space. Looking. Mm. Nolan Sargent unable to make the catch. High pass for Sargent. Went through his hands, and C.J. Hurd was there to deliver the hit to make sure that Sargent did not come down with it.
Hanging up just a little bit too much.
Can't see Hurd's number from the backside because of those flowing locks, but easy to identify. Where's number 1? But you can see it from the front, but from the back you can see he just looks like a great athlete, which obviously he's in. Yeah. He's going to Florida State. So lots of great athletes out there tonight for the War Eagles. Under 5 minutes to go now, third quarter, 2nd and 10 for McCauley. Handoff, McMahon. Mm. First man misses, second man does not, and a short gain. On the play again in the middle of that defense was Johnny Okolo, the junior. Number 57, being marked for a loss of about a yard. It's going to bring up 3rd down and 11, clock running, 4:36, 4:35 in the third quarter, 20-7 McCauley. Inside Elliot Arnold's field goal range at this point for McCauley. Let's see what Coach wants to do here, 3rd down and 11. St. Hilaire waiting for the snap. Back, looking. down the sideline looking for Carson Lawrence. The pass is caught, and he is marked out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
Wow.
20 yards on the completion.
What a great throwing
catch. Saint-Hilaire to Carson Lawrence. Lawrence being covered out there by R.J. Harrison. Lawrence has about 4 inches on him.
Yeah, he just went up and got it.
And Harrison never really saw that ball out of the air. Lawrence did. Got 1 foot down, and now it's first and goal, McCauley. 4:11 remaining, third quarter. The Blue Tornado up by 13. Big completion there on third down, Coach. And now let's see if the Blue Tornado can punch it in. Carson Gentle in motion. Saint-Hilaire. McMahon up the middle, looking. Knifing, driving forward. A scrum in the middle of the field. It's not over yet. McMahon driving, and he's going to be down at the 1 yard line. I think first contact was made by Amari Irvin, number 33. And then it was just all hands on deck, both sides pushing, and McCauley got the better of that. Initial contact probably around the 3 yard line, but the ball ends up at the 1, second down, and goal inside the 1. Looks like about the 1 foot line. 3:38, clock running, third quarter. McCauley with a chance to push back out to a 3-score lead as it begins to get late here in the game. Tight formation. Let's see if they go to the quarterback sneak. Nope, it's a pitch to the near side, and he's going to walk in.
How about that?
Javon McMahon. What Carson Gentle out there sealing the edge. 22, Ryan Larrabee. And Larrabee just put J.L.S. Hood right on his back, and McMahon walked in. 1 yard touchdown run, Javon McMahon. Again, credit on the outside. Carson Gentle out there, 22, the junior. Yeah. Ryan Larrabee makes a big block. And McCauley pushes the lead out to 26-7.
That was a great job there. Great call. They had them packed in there, and they weren't protecting the edge very good.
Yeah, tight formation, and you just wonder if you can get to the edge with the speed.
Yeah.
And by formation, they kind of got the advantage, and then a good seal block on the outside opens the way for the touchdown. So, Coach, late in the game like this, when you call a running play like that and it's executed as that was executed, you got to feel good about what that means is happening up front with your offensive line, right? And you talked before this drive started, you talked about trying to shorten the game, or a few minutes before that, shortening the game. And certainly keeping the ball on the ground and then scoring is a way to do that.
Yeah, we were trying to establish the line of scrimmage, and then they didn't let us there a couple times, and then all of a sudden we hit the big pass and then the big touchdown run.
That big strike on third down from Saint-Hilaire to Carson Lawrence that got McCauley into first and goal, set that up. And here come the Blue Tornado again, attempting the extra point. Elliot Arnold. Snap, hold, kick. He is good. And so with 3:19 remaining in the third quarter, after the big strike from McCauley and the big strike from Woodward, McCauley takes the ball back down the field and punches it into the end zone to push the lead back out to 20 points. It's McCauley 27 and Woodward Academy 7 with 3:19 remaining in the third quarter.
Had 13 points in the first half, and now we've got 3 scores.
That's right. It's an offensive extravaganza here. As soon as the fireworks started going off, things started happening here. Now for McCauley on defense, you've seen what Woodward can do in that last drive, I think, was 2 plays. So, obviously, 2 plays, 80 yards. So, obviously, if you're McCauley, you got to you got to feel good about scoring, but you can't let up your guard because Grice can go 80 yards on you. You've got Abdullah can go 80 yards. They have so many athletes out there.
You got to keep being aggressive on defense, which coach is talking about that all the time. You know, playing on the balls of your feet.
The ball is falling off the tee.
Playing to get beat. And you'll make a mistake every now and then. But, you know, the name of the game is getting after them, trying to force them to do some things that they don't want to do.
So much speed for Woodward, and as we expect, they're going to be opening up the game plan and going downfield a lot more. This is really going to be a challenge for this McCauley defense. Fielded by Abdullah at the 2, looking up the middle, 20. Ooh, knife down. Flag comes in late. Looked like there might have been a seam opening up, but Bear Cortez again,
nice
through and makes special teams tackle, and a flag comes flying in at the 17-yard line on the near side. I'll wait for the call. Personal foul.
Blocked blew the waist.
Woodward. Well, you put the two fists together. Is this an illegal blindside block? We saw the signal last week. This is one I haven't seen before in high school. The official took his two fists and shoved and hit them together. We saw it as 15-yard penalty last week. So, folks, I apologize. I'll have to do some research. That's one I haven't seen before. But now I've seen it 2 weeks in a row, so I need to get on this. In any event, it's another big penalty that pushes Woodward back inside the 10-yard line to the 9. First and 10 from the 9. Another big 15-yard penalty. Abdullah in motion. Looking out to the side. Pass is complete. For a first down, Marshall to Jerome Bettis Jr. Gain of 12 yards out to the 21-yard line. First down and 10. You expect Woodward's going to probably pick up the tempo here. 3 minutes remaining. Clock running in the third quarter. Down now three scores again, 27-7. Bettis to the far side. Roman Stamps, number 11, comes near side with Josiah Abdullah. And Grice is in the slot to the far side. Griffin Marshall back. Low snap. He's got it. Scrambling out of there, and he'll slide. And, oh, he's hit by a McCauley player, and that's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Well, athletic play. Griffin Marshall, the snap was low. He picked it off the turf. And the timing of the play was ruined. He scrambled out of the pocket to try to get a couple yards. Went down feet first, and Carson Lawrence hit him after he was on the ground. And that's another huge penalty. 15 yards will give the War Eagles a first down at the 41-yard line. 2:34, third quarter. Well, so athletic play by Marshall, trying to get a few yards, and then a gift there from the McCauley defense. Another mental error coach gives them another 15 yards. Which now puts McCauley over 100 yards for the evening.
Yeah, those are killers.
First down and 10 now. Four wide receivers. Back looking. Pressure up the middle. The ball is away and high and incomplete for Josiah Abdullah. Pressure right up the gut from McCauley. And in the backfield was 32 Bear Cortez and 54 Etienne Serrano. So I think that pressure affected that throw, Coach, because Abdullah had a step on the outside. Long throw from the quarterback under normal circumstances, but the defender was right in his face. The ball sails high and out of bounds. And it brings up second down and 10 from the 41.
Yeah, you throw off your back foot instead of letting it go like a fastball.
Grice and Bettis to the near side. Looking back to the near. Oh, he's going to go down. So Marshall faked to the right. Looks like they had set up some kind of a screen to the near side, but it wasn't materializing. And from his blind side, before he could get it off, Olivier Camerlane met him in the backfield. Camerlane playing both ways tonight. A little bit of defense, we talked earlier, on the offensive line, some plays on defense, and that's a big play for McCauley.
This doesn't look good.
We see the ball. We see the officials walking forward again. So what do we have? A flag way downfield. Personal foul. A face mask. And the face mask, interestingly, happened about 10 yards downfield, it seemed like.
It could be on that wide out. I didn't see it, but it could have been on the receiver at the top.
Another.
We were pressing it.
15-yard penalty. Brings it to the 44-yard line of McCauley. First down and 10. 153, 152, third quarter. McCauley giving away yards and chunks on penalties. And in trouble again. Looking to get out of the pocket. He goes down for a sack. The ball is on the ground, and McCauley has it. Recovery by 32, Bear Cortez. And I think it was 54, Serrano, who really was in there again on the quarterback. So you saw Griffin Marshall under pressure, trying to get away. And I do think it was Serrano who got the sack. Ball came free. 32, the junior, Bear Cortez, Johnny on the spot. And it's first down, McCauley, at the 47-yard line. So, boy, McCauley dodges a bullet there, Coach. 30 yards and penalties against them on that drive in their own territory. Woodward has something going, and then McCauley is the beneficiary of an ill-timed turnover.
Yeah, two bad plays for us with the penalties, but a real bad play for them when the ball gets on that ground. So that's
and that was a first down play. So that was could have been second and long. Instead, it's McCauley's ball now heading the other direction, just inside their own territory, 47-yard line, 1:40 remaining in the third quarter. And now we may come back, Coach, to that run game we talked about, trying to shorten the game. First down. Nope, it's a pass. St. Hilaire out to the side to Enrique James LeClaire. He's knocked out after a gain of 4 yards. And as Jay St. Hilaire released the ball, London Merritt was greeting him once again. Merritt has been, as advertised tonight, Coach, off the edge, wreaking havoc all night. And the bad news is he's only a junior. The good news is I hope that Jeff Romero doesn't schedule these guys again so we don't have to see him. But we'll see. London Merritt has been a terror tonight, as advertised. Number zero.
That was a great throw and catch over right there. I mean, we'll take second six, second five.
Hand off up the middle. There's McMahon pushing forward. 3-4 yards. Looking to leave third and two. So as we do recognize the great players on the defensive line, but again, Coach, let's circle back to the offensive line. Doing just enough on plays like that, right? Yep. Keep the ball moving. So four new starters, and they're facing players of this ability.
Well, they're growing up.
They are growing up fast,
this
right?
Ball game
and after this game, next week, you get Cincinnati St. Xavier coming down, so it doesn't get any easier. Big drive here for this offensive line, and McCauley, clock running with a minute to go in the third quarter. Boy, and if you love offensive and defensive line play, this has been a great game to watch tonight on both sides of the ball for both teams. Third and short. Faking, rolling, looking, pass complete. Is it caught by Taboteau? It is. He's out of bounds for a first down. Jay St. Hilaire with a rollout to the left, and he finds 24 Taboteau out of bounds at the 31-yard line, 14 yards on the completion on third and two. So we'll fake handoff inside, rolls out to the throws against his body. Good throw, good catch. 44 seconds in the third quarter. First and goal, first and 10, McCauley, 32-yard line. Looking now to maybe salt this game away. Handoff, McMahon off the left side. He's got some space. Good block out there by Hebert. Pushed out of bounds on the edge. Tyree Myrick and 33, Amari Irvin. On the stop, big gain on first down of 8 yards, Coach. And now you see.
Boy, you like them second two calls.
It's great, easy to be a great coach when it's second and two instead of second and 12.
Yeah, or second 10, yeah.
So second down now, McCauley. Pushed out of bounds. The clock stopped, 39 seconds to go. Let's see if they're just going to pound it or maybe going to run some play action and try to find something deep. St. Hilaire back looking. Short pass across the middle. McMahon, he breaks the tackle. He's at the five. He is into the end zone.
Oh,
Javon McMahon, the senior, bounces off a tackle in the middle, being defended by Amari Irvin. Irvin hits him, bounces off, and McMahon takes it the rest of the way. 24 yards for the touchdown. Jay St. Hilaire to Javon McMahon. And what a weapon, Coach, from McMahon coming out of the backfield can catch the ball.
He's got good speed. He's got great leg drive, and he can catch the ball. You can use him in a lot of different ways.
Arnold's kick. Perfect. Well, we are inside a minute. Great. Yeah, go ahead, Coach.
Just keep him healthy. You know, that's because he can do – you know, he also can be a really, really good defensive player. But you're playing pretty good defense when your defense is standing on the sideline.
That's right. You keep them on the sidelines. So 32 seconds now inside a minute of the third quarter. McCauley with a 34-7 lead. And I don't think there's really anybody who saw this coming tonight. When you look at the quality of the opponent, again, a long way to go. Still a full quarter plus to go. And we saw earlier how quickly Woodward can strike. But an impressive performance
our
through the
front
third quarter for McCauley.
So well. Yeah, our front has played so well. Three-man pressure, four-man pressure. You know, and then when you bring five, I mean, that's even better.
McCauley will kick from the 40-yard line. Elliot Arnold. Two men back deep. Abdullah's back there. Here comes a kick. High and shorter. Looks like he's going to have a return, and he does from the 4. Up the middle, he's got a lane. And he's got to the outside. Let's see. He's pulled out to the 38-yard line. Let's get that. That was not Abdullah. That's 18, Zayden Young, with a great kickoff return out to the 39-yard line. About 34 yards on that return for Young. So my apologies. I thought it was 13 Abdullah, but it was not. It was 18 Young. Well, Coach, here come the War Eagles. 22 seconds remaining. Third quarter, 34-7. Shotgun formation. That's a new quarterback. Handoff up the gut is to Lucas Farrington. He's got a first down. And Landon Walker, the junior, number 17, is now in at quarterback, replacing Griffin Marshall. First down run of 11 yards to the 50-yard line. Clock running inside, 5 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1, and that's going to be the end of the third quarter. Well, an exciting third quarter. We saw a lot of offense after a real defensive battle in the first half. And the long play from Woodward, the 84-yard touchdown, but McCauley notches several touchdowns, right, with several big plays there. And now the Blue Tornado will go into the fourth quarter with a big lead, 34-7, as we head into the final 12 minutes of play. We'll take a short break. We'll be right back here with you folks for the final 12 minutes of tonight's game here at Finley Stadium. So back here, awaiting the start of the fourth quarter. McCauley leading 34-7, a game that was 13-0 at halftime. One touchdown in the first quarter. Coach, 4 touchdowns in the third quarter. McCauley on the plus side of that, scoring 3 of those 4. And now with a big 27-point lead, backup quarterback Walker in the game. First and 10. Back to pass, looking, pressure. Looking down the right sideline, complete.
Wow.
In the double coverage, complete to Jerome Bettis Jr., number 4. And he's down at about the 12-yard line. So the War Eagles seem to have found something here with Landon Walker. Not a lot of air under that pass, Coach, but it was right where it needed to be for 38 yards and a big first down to the 15-yard line. Life yet for Woodward Academy. And some new faces out there, including at the quarterback position, and so far has reaped some early rewards. 11 and a half minutes remaining. McCauley up. Back to pass, looking out to the left. That one's going to fall short, and he had several hands in his face. Bear Cortez, 32. Carson Gentle, 17. And Paul Marie Doug Wee were all there to say hello to Mr. Walker, and the pass out toward Josiah Abdullah falls short, throwing off his back foot. Coach, well,
we're controlling the last scrimmage up front.
And that was huge thing that Coach Bradford talked about. Who's going to control the line of scrimmage? And at the same, McCauley has had the better of it tonight and still the case in the fourth quarter. But again, Long way to go. 11 and a half minutes to go. Second and 10. Man in motion is Abdullah. Looking. Lots of room. He has broken the pocket, heading for the corner of the end zone, and he's in for the touchdown. Landon Walker, 15-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, we came after him, and so everybody's chasing a wide out. That quarterback's running up their back. So.
And a flag goes down. I think we're going to have a penalty against, I think it's going to be Josiah Abdullah. For some displays of histrionics there after the play was over. We'll see. It was well after the play, and the flag is out at the 14-yard line, correction. Let's see. Something happened down there, and you saw Abdullah making some gestures. So let's see what the call is. Coming over to talk to Coach Potter. I think this is going to be against Woodward then. They're giving him the choice. Correction, Coach?
Or
correct.
Yeah.
If they're going to how they're going to assess this.
Yeah.
Dead ball on sportsmanlike conduct. And it was Josiah Abdullah, 13, for Woodward Academy. The official's talking, but none of us can hear him. We know it was a personal.
Yeah, so they're going to take it on the kickoff, so. Which is good. I mean, that will get good field position.
And to attempt the extra point for Woodward. Kick is up. And it's good. And so, in the early stages of the fourth quarter, 11:21 remaining here in the ball game, and Woodward goes down and scores. 17, Landon Walker comes off the bench, a quarterback, leads him down the field, scrambles out of the pocket after evading the blitz, and ducks into the left corner of the end zone for a touchdown. And as we mentioned with the penalty, McCauley will add the 15 yards on, so the War Eagles will kick off from their own 25-yard line. McCauley hoping to have good field position. And, Coach, I've never, no matter whom I'm rooting for, I've never understood talking smack when you're down 30 points. And here it's going to cost them 15 yards.
Well, that's a frustration thing. You know, it's just, I mean, they didn't anticipate being down 34-7.
And you know, if McCauley were doing it, Coach Potter would be equally frustrated.
Oh, yeah, wow.
So yeah. That's where my students tell me I'm old because I'm not a big fan of that. But that's part of many games now, right? Baseball is a part of the game. Football is a part of the game. There's a lot more talking that goes on than maybe when we played it. So I have to adjust. But apparently, in that case, whatever happened went beyond the pale. And that's actually the second 15-yard penalty for unsportsmanlike conduct tonight that has impacted. The War Eagles, McCauley has had their own fair share of penalties tonight with face masks and other kinds of penalties, so it's not at all been a clean game. Both coaches will have things they can talk about to clean up. And after all is said and done and the dust settles, the War Eagles will kick off from their own 25-yard line. DeClaire is back deep. I think that's Carson Lawrence with him on the far side of the field. And certainly whatever is happening down there, you hope it doesn't continue to progress. You don't want a great game between two great teams like this to end with any kind of problems. Obviously, these are great athletes on both sides, so let's hope that everyone can settle back into the game. We can get back to playing football. There's Enrique James LeClaire at the 20-yard line. Coming to the near side, gets a block, breaks one tackle, breaks two tackles at the 50, inside the 45-yard line.
Uh-oh. Looks like we got a flag, so that's...
Brought down, that's Tyree Myrick again, who makes a play and gets up hobbling again. Looks like he's bravely fighting through what looks like cramps.
It's 33-yard
return, but I think you're right, Coach. Some of this is going to come back. There's almost never a penalty against the kicking team when the flag is thrown downfield. It is. Illegal block against McCauley, and we just talked about penalties, and there's another one. So great return that takes them inside the 45-yard line, but based upon the spot of the foul, instead they're back at their own 34-yard line. So a huge penalty. That's a 20-plus yard penalty. Technically it's 10 yards, but you take it back from the spot of the foul, it's really cost McCauley 20 yards of field position. And these are things that both sides, they're going to, as the year goes on, right, these things will get cleaned up. And both of these teams are going to be absolutely loaded, locked, and ready for playoff time. Obviously, Woodward had a great run in the playoffs last year. You can expect that again from this very talented team. McCauley hoping to make noise in the playoff as well. Hit and dropped, and a flag is going to come in late. So St. Hilaire was hit. The pass was short for Nolan Sargent, and the foul is going to be on Christian Bell, 24. It's a personal foul. I think the call is that he, after the throw was away, he drove him into the ground.
Drove him into the ground, yeah.
And that's, I would describe that as a fairly modern interpretation of what can and can't be done to the quarterback. Probably not a penalty in previous years, but now a lot more emphasis on protecting the quarterback, and so it's a personal foul and penalty yards again. We'll have to get a calculator to figure out how many total penalty yards we've had tonight, but it's been a lot of laundry on the field tonight.
We've been fortunate. We've been able to overcome the penalties. They haven't.
First down, the 49-yard line. St. Hilaire faking, looking, hit again, downfield, looking for Tabuteau, incomplete. And 21 down there is J. Ellis Hood again. Good play by Hood. Tabuteau was there. Throw maybe a little behind Tabuteau. He had to stop. And Hood covered the ground and made a great play. He's been a busy man over there tonight, J. Ellis Hood. And a great performance by him tonight on that side for the War Eagles, yeah, for sure. He has really been a... He's really stood out in my eyes watching because a lot's been placed on him with the formations and the plays that McCauley has run, and he has been, in almost every case, right up to the task.
Made the play, yeah.
Second down and 10. It's fumble snap. McMahon breaks one tackle.
Well, that was a great job right there making yards.
Boy, he gets a positive play, but it looked like it could have been a disaster. The ball on the ground in the backfield, Aiden Hughes wrestles him down after a short gain of 4 yards. Brings up third down and a long 6 for McCauley. The clock's 10:40 and running. Fourth quarter.
That's a nice job with ball security because he's doing all that spinning and stuff, but he's keeping that ball high and tight and making yards.
And, folks, my apologies for being slow on the quarter indication on the screen. That's part of my job. That's why they pay me the big bucks, and slow on that. First down, run. And a flag's coming in. So great run by Javon McMahon, but two flags come in. There are helmets on the field. And let's see what this is going to be. Three flags on the field. Right in the same spot. So let's see what this is what the call is going to be. Number 5, Caden Morris, was running downfield in on the play without his helmet. And let's see, was his helmet ripped off, or is it a penalty for continuing to be in the play without the helmet, which I think is a penalty at the high school level, if I'm not mistaken, Coach. And I think that's the call. And it's going to give first down run plus a penalty.
Well.
On 19 on the run. Thank you. And plus a penalty, which is going to take the ball way down inside War Eagles territory. By the time they stop walking, it's all the way at the 14-yard line. So, Coach, I think that was the call. And, boy, unfortunate if a player like Cade Morris, who's just hustling down the field to try to stay in the game, and if that's the call, that's a tough one to take. It's a great hustle play, but I guess it's an issue of safety. I understand that, but... this is the backup running back in for McCauley now.
Yes, it's Keelan.
That's 26, Keelan Siam, the junior. Powerful, low to the ground. And late in the game, when you have maybe the defense a little bit tired, you bring him in. You can see he's thick, he's strong, and he's not really going to try to make you miss. He's just going to try to run right through you. Let's see what happens here on second down now. It's again, makes one man miss. But good play in the backfield there to stop his forward momentum. So 33 is Amari Irvin. He didn't end up making the tackle, but he really made that play by forcing CM to stop his feet and try to restart. And that's going to bring up now third down and goal from the 3. CM the junior. Clock running, 9:04, 9:03. Running down the play clock. The play clock at 10. No hurry here from McCauley. Trying to shorten the game. St. Hilaire coming under center. Siama is the setback. Pitch to the right. Looking. Cutting inside and into the end zone for a touchdown. Ryan Larrabee out there leading the way along with Phil Buteau. And for the second time tonight, McCauley packs it in and runs the pitch to the outside and scores a touchdown.
Yep.
McCauley takes a lead now of 40-14. And what a luxury late in the game to have fresh legs like Siam to come in and try to salt this game away. 8:45 still remaining, but boy, every time Woodward has punched in the second half, McCauley has been able to punch back to this point. And the extra point is good. 41-14, Blue Tornado with 8:45 remaining in the game. So, Coach, I said it a few minutes ago, but I'll say it again now. This is not something I saw coming tonight.
No, I don't think anybody did. I think they had some missed opportunities. We had some missed opportunities in the first half. We started making plays in the second half, and they still had some missed opportunities and some penalties. We made some plays and some big plays, and that's why we're up 41-14. It's credit to these kids. I mean, we've made some mistakes with penalties, but they have really executed and overcome them to be beating a good football team right now.
And yeah, make no mistake about it, at the end of the year, when it comes time for playoffs in Georgia, Woodward's going to be there. So much talent, Coach Hunt, with a great group of players over there. Coach Potter, you know, give them credit, right? They really, and Coach Bradford on the offensive side, Coach Potter primarily in charge of defense, all the assistant coaches who've spent a lot of time, I know, getting ready for this game this week. And an impressive performance tonight so far, to be sure, for the Blue Tornado. Elliot Arnold out to kick off again. Low kick will not make it to the end zone. Well, it was. Mm-hmm. It skips by. Abdullah was back in the game. Josiah Abdullah was back in. The ball skips by him into the end zone. And here come the War Eagles. I think we're seeing some new faces out there for Woodward. And we might see, let's see if we notice any changes on the defensive side for McCauley, or is it still too early for that? Let's see. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Clock is at 8:45 in the fourth quarter, and I expect we are going to see, well, now we see another quarterback. This is number 9, Charles Maxell Jr. is in at quarterback for the War Eagles. So Walker leads him down the field for a score, but we have another quarterback in. Hand off at the middle. There's a gap and a big gain of 9 yards. Tackle by Carson Lawrence, and the running back is also, looks like he's new in the game. Let me find him here. 27, Joshua Isom, with a quick hit up right up the middle for 9 yards to the 29-yard line.
That's a good job by Carson getting him on the ground, because if he don't get him on the ground.
There wasn't much behind him, was there?
Yeah,
except a lot of green turf.
Somebody was going to have to run him down.
A lot of green turf, and it's second down and one. Clock running 8:13. Fourth quarter, McCauley with a big lead. Isom takes a snap, fakes the handoff, cuts it up. He's got a big hole in the middle of the field. He's away. He's going to be caught from behind by Marcellus Barnes Jr., but a big play there by Charles Maxwell Jr. And little run-pass option, fakes the handoff, cuts it up, and goes down the field. Now, McCauley has been changing some personnel, so this is not the same defensive personnel we've seen to this point, but that's a big run of 50 yards down to the 31-yard line of McCauley. Clock running, 7:40, fourth quarter. McCauley in charge, but the War Eagles are marching again. Snap, hand off up the middle, and that time there was nothing. 27, Isom again on the carry. Met in the hole by 55, Olivia Camerlane, who takes him down. Second down and 11, a loss of a yard. Tremari Watkins, 78, is also now out there in the middle of that defensive line. So still some of the starters out there for McCauley. A couple of personnel changes now with second and 11. Clock under 7 minutes to go. Maxwell takes the snap. Hit as he throws. Ball up in the air and out of bounds. A big shot delivered by Camerlane. And Maxwell gets up off his back. Looks like he's going to be okay, but he took a big shot on that play. The pass was intended for Jerome Bettis Jr., but it sailed high and well out of bounds. Good coverage down there for McCauley as well. But Camerlane came knifing through and had a free shot on the quarterback. And that leaves third down and 11, 6:47, fourth quarter. McCauley leading 41-14. Abdullah in motion. Shotgun snap back, looking. Passes to Bettis and through his hands and incomplete. Jerome Bettis Jr. pass was a little above his helmet, but it looked like it was right there, Coach.
It was just catchable, yeah.
Went through his hands, maybe off his fingertips. Looked like a catchable ball there delivered by the quarterback, but falls incomplete. And that brings up fourth down and 11 with 6:43 remaining.
Sometimes when you're getting beat 41-14, you just kind of lose your focus a little bit.
And as we said, for many reasons tonight, both coaches are going to have plenty of things to talk about in the film room. Lots of room for both these teams as they move forward with some missed opportunities and some self-inflicted wounds on both sides tonight. Shotgun snap, fourth and 11, back, looking. Pass is caught, I think. But I believe he's going to be short of the first down. Depends on the spot. It's going to be close. That was Bettis Jr. who went up and got that. Surrounded by two defenders. And they're giving him forward progress to the 21. I think that's going to be a first down, and it is. Wow.
Well, that was a
favorable spot.
Yeah, two folks over there.
But a great throw and catch. Looked like a bit of a favorable spot, but give Bettis credit. He went up and after just
those are the things
one,
you
right?
thought we'd see in the first half.
Exactly. Yeah, great catch there. He comes back, makes the play the next time he has the opportunity on fourth and long. They connect, and it's first down and from the 21-yard line as the clock runs under 6.5 minutes. And there you see those flashes again, as you say, Coach, of the talent that is on this Woodward team. And you've seen McCauley all night kind of finding a way to answer. Grice is wide open across the middle, and he just can't come up with the play. McCauley sent the blitz. Chosen Lacombe was in the backfield, putting pressure on the quarterback. And what's interesting about McCauley, and I talked about this some with Coach Bradford, they play a lot of teams that have more, I guess, recruits going to some of the big name schools. And McCauley, the coaches, they seem to always be much greater than the sum of their parts. And so you see that sometimes we match up against teams with athletes and you think, how are we going to match up?
You got a good plan.
And somehow they do it, right? These players who they're not going to go to maybe some of the universities other people are.
Tough-minded kids.
But they find a way to get it done. There's a long pass down their sideline, incomplete. And the quarterback again took a shot there from Camerlane.
Coach Potter's not going to let him sit back here and pat that ball. He's going to make him get rid of it.
Even late in the game, right? So third down and 10. But you do see you're trying to game plan against a team with so much talent and so much speed. And so credit to Woodward for what they bring to the table and credit to the McCauley coaches for having a game plan to try to control that, which they have in general done fairly well tonight, giving up 14 points to this point in the game. Third down and 10, rolling out to the left. Here comes pressure again. Pass to Abdullah is caught. He's out of bounds at the 14-yard line, it looks like. So going to bring up another fourth down, and Lacombe pushed him out of bounds. Fourth down and 4, maybe closer to 3. Ball keeps inching forward. Now it's at the 14-yard line. They need to get to the 11. Fourth down and 3. 6:03, clock has stopped. Fourth quarter, McCauley leading 41-14. The third quarterback we've seen tonight for Woodward is Charles Maxwell Jr. taking a couple shots on this drive, but he's still out there fighting. Made some Some good plays, takes a snap, fourth down, pressure in his face, throws it to the side, and complete to number 12. There's Ben Grice. 6 yards on the completion to the 9-yard line. Correction, 5 yards on the completion to the 9-yard line. First and goal from the 9, 5:59 remaining in the game. McCauley really, apart from that one play, the one big play, the 84-yard touchdown, McCauley's done a pretty good job of containing Grice.
Yeah, they're making
Grice
him earn it right here. Yep.
And Grice, great speed, and he comes out of that slot.
Those quarterbacks they keep putting in there, they got some pretty good skills.
You've seen some of the most effective drives recently have been the second and third players in at the quarterback position. Like a hold on the edge, not going to be called. He's rolling out to the right and gets to the 5-yard line before he's brought down by Deshaun Tipton. Tipton, correction. And you could see Eitan Serrano was coming off the edge, and he got hooked, no call, but late in the game, just kind of keep putting pressure. As you say, keep putting pressure on the quarterback. 5.5 minutes clock running in the game. Inside the 5 now, second down and goal. See the fatigue on the McCauley side now with players with hands on hips. Trying to push through these final 5 minutes and 17 seconds, clock running. Maxwell takes a snap, looking to the corner of the end zone for Grice. It is incomplete. Pressure in his face. He got rid of it. Lacombe out in coverage and Carson Lawrence out in that corner of the end zone as well. Throw a little bit off, and Grice had to try to spin to make a one-handed catch, unable to haul the ball in. It brings up third down and goal now from the 5-yard line.
Yeah, Chris Potter's not going to let him set his feet. Now he's getting after him.
Timeout by the War Eagles. 5:05 remaining, their first timeout of the second half. 41-14 is the score.
We're pressuring him. We're doing a great job of playing man, too. You know, getting being around. I mean, we're making them make good catches when they do catch it.
Well, 5 minutes to go, and so what are the coaches telling him? Coach Potter, the main, obviously the head defensive coach. I see Coach Bradford out there in the middle of that pile as well. What are you saying to your guys here on third and goal? You got a big lead, but it's still, there are things you want to accomplish as a team. So what's Coach Potter telling them? What's the message this late in the game
in this
situation?
He's telling them we're going to come after him again, and, you know, we just got to do a great job of covering them. We're not, you know, he's not, we're not sitting back on our heels. he's bringing 5 and 6.
And you see some
of the
coaches.
That's probably what he told them, that we're coming after him, and they're going to have to make, yeah, that's the thing about it. When you do that, you make them make plays. And right now they haven't had the time. They've made some plays. They've moved the chains a little bit, but nothing big. Because our guys have been right in their face.
I think that was Coach Haar out there very actively coaching up the defensive line on maybe the move he wants them to try to use to get free, to get in the backfield. We'll see what Coach Potter draws up here. Third and goal from the 5. 4 wideouts. Grice in motion. Looking to the corner.
Wow.
Touchdown, Jerome Bettis Jr. So they brought Grice in motion to the near side, cleared out the far side,
created
and Jerome Bettis Jr. was out there against Marcellus Barnes, the Virginia Tech commit, and on this play, it was Maxwell and Bettis who got the better of the play and tucked in the corner of the end zone for a touchdown. Third touchdown of the evening. And on the attempt, the extra point. To bring the War Eagles back within 20 is the kicker, Hangus. Kick is low liner, but it makes it through.
Yep.
5 minutes exactly remaining in the game, 41-21. McCauley with the advantage over the War Eagles from Woodward Academy. The War Eagles band. striking up the fight song.
You know, we didn't give up big plays. We made them work, made them earn it, made them make plays, and they did make some plays. But that's what you got to do.
So you give up the touchdown, Coach, but it take you're saying you didn't give up the big play, right? So you're taking time off the clock.
Yeah.
As that's okay. So you're
making them make plays, and up until now, they have struggled to make those plays, but then they kept getting 5 yards here, 6 yards there, and moving the ball down the field, and give them guys credit. They made plays.
Well, here comes Woodward, trailing by 20 with 5 minutes to go. Should we expect a straight kickoff? Should we expect any, as this amazingly created English word, trickeration? Should we expect something along those lines, or do you think they're just going to kick it deep and play defense? You should have to be ready for anything.
I think he's going to kick it deep and play defense, you know. But I've been wrong many times before, so.
Angus lines up for the kick. It is a squib, and it's on the ground, and I think, well, it's still rolling.
How about that?
I think the War Eagles have it, and they do. The ball was bouncing around. The official is signaling that the ball is going their direction, and it's number 6, Tyree Myrick, who's been all over the field tonight, who finally makes the recovery off the onside kick, and so here comes Woodward with the ball at the McCauley 47-yard line.
That was a great kick.
Got the really good AstroTurf
bounce,
right?
Yeah.
And it bounced several times. There was an initial bounce you thought someone was gonna get. The ball kept rolling around, and
the more it rolls around, the better chance the kicking team's got. So
saw a McCauley player go to try to make the recovery, but not there in time. And Myrick, who's been fighting with cramps all night, continued to be out there. He's been a gamer all night. He makes the play there, and now the War Eagles have the ball back, trailing by 20. And now we see Walker back in the quarterback, and he is greeted by Bear Cortez 4 yards deep in the backfield. So Maxwell came in and had success. Now Landon Walker is back on the field. And on first down, the pass play unsuccessful, 32, Bear Cortez with the sack. Brings up second down and 14. Clock running 4.5 minutes, fourth quarter. McCauley with a 20-point lead. Shotgun formation, 4 wide receivers. 3-man rush. Here comes Cortez. Pressure again. Short pass is complete.
Oh, great job. Great tackle.
Short pass to Joshua Isom is complete. But that was, I think that was Buto, if I'm correct, on the play there for McCauley. So 3-man rush. Cortez came on a late delayed blitz. Short little pass across the middle for a gain of 5. Brings up 3rd down and 9 from the McCauley 46. Clock running 3:46.
The concept with that 3-man front is to push the pressure inside and get the quarterback outside the pocket. And then Bear did a great job of doing what he's supposed to do.
4 men coming now, 5 on the rush from McCauley. In his face, throw across the middle to Abdullah, incomplete, and Bear Cortez putting the quarterback, Landon Walker, on his back as he released the ball, brings up 4th down and 9. So that time, 4-man front, and they brought Cortez. As you said, Coach, they're not going to let the quarterback sit back and set his feet even this late in the game. Pays off there with pressure.
Make plays, yeah.
4th and 9. From the 46-yard line, McCauley defense looks to the sideline to get the call. Jerome Bettis Jr. to the far side. 3 wide receivers to the near side. Walker awaits a snap. 4-man rush back, looking. Pressure up the middle. He is brought down from behind. First contact right from down. Carson Gentle, and then a flag comes down. So Gentle hit him. Paul-Marie Dugui was there as well, and then a flag came down late. So McCauley with a sack on 4th down, but let's see. personal foul, face mask.
Wow.
Against McCauley. So it had to be on Doug Wee because Gentle got him around the feet, around the legs, and brought him down. And Doug Wee came in and got him on the top half, the upper half, the torso, must have gotten his hand up on the face mask. And, boy, another costly penalty for McCauley. They have a sack on fourth down, and instead, after a 15-yard face mask penalty, it's a first down at the 31-yard line. And continue giving life to the War Eagles. 3 minutes remaining in this game. Fake handoff rolls out to the side. Walker and nothing doing. And who is it? It's Bear Cortez again,
now,
who's
Bear's
had a heck of a game tonight.
All over the field tonight.
That junior 32 Bear Cortez has been everywhere, especially in the second half. 4 yards on the loss. And second and 14, the clock running 2:43, 2:42. McCauley leading by 20. Landon Walker, backup quarterback, came in, left the game, came back in, attempting to lead another scoring drive here in the closing minutes of the game, 2.5 minutes. Jerome Bettis Jr. now to the near side of the field, 3 wides to the far side. Here comes Grice in motion. Looking, Walker, lots of time across the middle, incomplete, and a flag comes down. Pass intended for Josiah Abdullah. And the penalty is going to be on Sean Couvertier for hitting him, well, arriving early, I guess. Interesting pass. Look at the passes behind him, and Abdullah didn't even really make an attempt to catch the ball. But Couvertier makes contact, and I think that's the flag. It's going to be another big penalty against McCauley. And we must be approaching, I don't have the official numbers, but we have to be approaching or exceeding 150 yards at this point in the game, because there was 80 or 70 yards in the first half, and I can think of, I think, 5 15-yard penalties in the second half against McCauley. So lots and lots of penalties. Keep the drive alive. 2:13 in the fourth quarter. Walker rolling out to the right. Lots of space. Short pass is complete to Abdullah, out of bounds. Marked at the 14-yard line, second down and 4.
Just flooding that area over there. Got a deep one, got a deep out, and then a short out.
2:07 remaining.
Making them throw the short out's the best thing there.
This drive began with the onside kick. After the War Eagles went down and scored, they recovered the onside kick. And with the assistance of several 15-yard penalties, they're now inside the 15-yard line, second and 4. Walker back, pressured from behind and brought down. And at this point, you almost wait for the flag. No flag on this play. That was Carson Gentle, the Tennessee commit, in the backfield with the sack. Brings up third down and 6 for the War Eagles. 1:48 remaining. Clock is running. Grice, it looks like on Grice's left hand, he has maybe some kind of a wrap or a cast. Yeah. You wonder if that's been a factor tonight. But still, he's I don't know what his receiving total is, but it's certainly well over 100 yards. Looking that side toward Grice now and unable to make the play. And we're pretty far away up here in the press box, and I wonder if there's something happening with that hand that has perhaps impacted him on a play like that, Coach, because that's normally a play that is...
You would think he'd be coming
fair,
up with
yeah,
that.
He's, that's yeah. fairly consistent for him to make that play on third down, but the ball falls incomplete, and it's going to bring up fourth down and 6. As I recall, Grice was injured in last year's game and missed a lot of the second half after having a big first half. But you saw on that 84-yard strike, just the electricity that he brings to the game. And so let's see if they go back his way on 4th and 6. Bettis and Grice to the near side. Abdullah crossed across the middle, intended for Josiah Abdullah. That time it's no good. Number 6, chosen Lokombe on the coverage. And the turnover on downs. McCauley will take over with 1:19 remaining in the game. And I might assume we're going to see the coach's favorite play, perhaps the victory formation here. But Woodward has 2 timeouts remaining, but even during those drives when the clock was running, they were not using the timeouts. So I don't expect we're going to see timeouts here. We may see two or three more snaps, and that may be it. The ball at the 16-yard line. St. Hilaire comes out up under center. McCauley is definitely in the victory formation. Snap, takes a knee, and that's what it's going to be. The clock's going to run out now. 1:15, probably two more snaps. Enrique James LeClaire is deep in this formation. And Tabuto and Javon McMahon are either side of St. Hilaire. 20 seconds on the play clock, 53 on the game clock. Second down and technically 11. Great win tonight from McCauley, Coach. This is doesn't get any easier, as we mentioned. The boys from Cincinnati come.
This is a great confidence builder right here. I mean, of all the penalties and all the things that kept, you know, shooting themselves in the foot a little bit, they just tough-minded kids and tough-minded coaches just kept putting the pressure on and made the plays when they had to. And
well, that's going to do it. The game clock is at 20. The play clock's at 24. And that's going to be it. Great show of class there by, who's that, number four, Jerome Bettis Jr. coming over and recognizing the officials. And you can see, by the way, these coaches and players are greeting each other. Great respect, mutual respect from both these teams. Great program from Atlanta. It's a really great opportunity for McCauley to play a program like this. Fortunate to come out on top tonight, 41-21. But definitely found out a lot about your team tonight, and best definitely some things to work on to clean up as you move forward in the season. So, Coach, what's your top takeaway or your top two takeaways from watching this game tonight from the McCauley perspective?
Well, I just think the resiliency. I think that, you know, that with all the penalties that kept setting them back or kept drives going for Woodward Academy, these kids just kept fighting. You know, they're just tough-minded, and they just kept fighting and kept putting the pressure on. The thing you take away from it is the playing. These kids really played pretty well. It's the other stuff that you got to get fixed. You know, it's the penalties and stuff that you got to address. And Coach Martin will address that. We got some playmakers on offense. I mean, you got all kinds of them. And then you put Okeechon in there and put the ball in his hands. So, you know, they're learning about their football team right now, too. So, I mean, you got some new defensive players, and so each week's a learning experience for them and a growing up experience. And then same thing with the offensive line. I mean, them guys are, you know, to play a good team like this and come out ahead – then it just, all it does is just kind of give you confidence. Coach Newman's going to, you know, he'll have some things to certainly work with them about. But again, if they'll just keep staying together and keep, growing up a little bit, then next week's not going to be any easier. But we ought to have enough confidence going into that game that we clean up the penalties. We got a chance to beat anybody.
So great win tonight for McCauley. You see both teams gathering with their coaches after the alma mater down here in front with the fans who are remaining. I know they had a couple of buses that came over from campus tonight, thanks to the Pep Band for being out here. And good show tonight by supporters of both teams. And, so quite a win, as you say, tonight, Coach, against a very good team out of Atlanta. A chance to kind of see where you land, right, as a marker for where you are in the season, and lots of good things to build on, some things to clean up as McCauley moves forward. So next week, I'm excited about this. I'm a Buckeye, so I'm excited to see St. X come down from the Greater Catholic League. I mean, we're every week's a war, so we'll see what they bring this year. And then the week after that, McCauley goes all the way over to Memphis to play MUS, and then after that gets into region play.
Then there's
right?
a gauntlet. There's Brentwood and then NBA and then Baylor.
We don't usually say that name on the air, Coach. There are children out there. We usually talk to the team across the river. But it's okay. It's after 10 o'clock, I guess. So,
yeah,
gauntlet coming up for McCauley. So, a big season coming up. for McCauley. Good start here with two good wins. A win last week against CCS. Slow start. Picked it up and ended up dominating in the second half of the game. And again tonight, close first half. 13-0 lead at half. McCauley ends up winning 41-21. And
the other thing that I saw, too, is, you know, Coach moved some people around trying to get, the best play people on the field offensively and defensively. And those kids stepped up. And then you got Bear Cortez that he gets his chance to start, and he makes the best of it.
All over the field. So some stats here. Thanks to Jeff Romero doing this all by hand up here. So first downs tonight, Woodward Academy with 13, McCauley with 21. So at halftime, as I recall, I think Woodward had two. So really the second half, their offense came alive, especially in the third and fourth quarter. Third down conversions, however, Woodward 0 for 10 on third down. McCauley 3 for 9, although 0 for 10, the asterisk has to be the number of times that we committed penalties on third down that gave them first downs, right? There were several times you had a face mask call or something else after we even stopped them on fourth down that extended the drive. But as far as just in the run of play, 0 for 10 for Woodward, penalties. Woodward, 8 penalties for 79 yards. For McCauley, 14 penalties for 160 yards. And I, as you mentioned earlier, I'm sure there will be some discussions about that over the days to come. Rushing yards for Woodward, 64 yards. McCauley, 138. So much better performance than last year on the ground against this talented team from the War Eagles. Passing, Jay St. Hilaire for McCauley, 17-32 for 240 yards. And the leading passer for Woodward was a starter, Griffin Marshall, 8 for 20 with 167 yards. The long touchdown to Grice, and then the two interceptions, big plays in the game as well. So McCauley moves out to 2-0 on the year. Still waiting a couple weeks out yet from region play coming off. Again, 5 consecutive 10-win seasons. The disappointment last year of coming up one play short, right? One extra point short in the state semis. And the coaches talked about the hunger that they saw, especially among these seniors coming out this year. They said every day, throughout the summer, every day of practice, you see the intensity, and definitely seems to be bearing some fruit early in the season with a big win, 41-20 over a very good team. And while the first half was coached, it was close, 41-21. In the second half, the game wasn't really that close. Never really in doubt once McCauley took that 34-7 lead after three quarters. So great win for McCauley tonight. As far as I could tell, really, both sides of the field, I didn't see any injured players. You want to come out of a game like this without injuries. I believe, from what we could tell, both teams came out without any kind of significant injuries tonight, which is always a good thing for both sides. And, you know, Coach Hunt has a lot of talent, and they're going to regroup. They're going to come out next week. They're going to be ready to go. Coach Potter, they're going to have something to talk about and come out next week to get going as well. So great night, though, for McCauley. If you're wearing blue here tonight, and the Blue Tornado go home happy tonight on a hot Saturday or Friday evening here at Finley Stadium. So once again, this is David Eastman for Coach Rick Witt, Lance Nolan on the camera, and Jeff Romero up here with us on stats and giving us all kinds of good information, saying good night from Finley Stadium, from the Border Wars. It's McCauley 41 and Woodward Academy 21. Good night, everybody.